Number two, a junior wide receiver from Thibodaux, Louisiana, Devontae Garrett. Number five, a sophomore quarterback from Sarasota, Florida, Arthur Brantley IV. Number 22, a freshman running back from Colorado Springs, Colorado, Nagarius Allgood. Number 53, a sophomore guard from Oak Park, Michigan, Luke Crocker. Number 57, a sophomore tackle from St. Clair Shores, Michigan, Anthony Marsiglio. Number 61, a sophomore center from Lake Orion, Michigan, Henry Bilecki. Number 69, a sophomore guard from Spokane, Washington, Josh Huffman. Number 71, a sophomore tackle from Sarasota, Florida, Horace Ewer. Number 85, a freshman wide receiver from Aurora, Colorado, DeMario Williams. And number 88, a sophomore tight end from Livonia, Michigan, Connor Kerrigan. And now, announcing the defensive starters for your Judson University Eagles. Number three, a sophomore safety from Mays Landing, New Jersey, Trey Sayers. Number four, a sophomore cornerback from Clinton, Maryland, Ryan Ote. Number six, a senior linebacker from Streamwood, Illinois, John Trail Mitchell. Number eight, a sophomore linebacker from Atlanta, Georgia, E.J. Glover. Number nine, a sophomore cornerback from Davenport, Iowa, Cameron Carter. Number 25, a junior linebacker from Belvedere, Illinois, Chance Crajean. Number 30, a freshman defensive end from Janesville, Wisconsin, Bryce Heary. Number 32, a freshman safety from Pensacola, Mai Tresrolls.
Love it. Guy wears size 16 talons.
Ladies and gentlemen, and all fans of Judson Athletics, and gentlemen, with us today to give our opening prayer is Pastor Jesse Mendoza. Pastor Mendoza is an associate pastor at Elgin New Life Covenant Church. New Life Covenant Church and lead pastor Avi Gracie are supporters of Judson University and the spiritual development Judson Scholar athletes. Pastor Mendoza.
Amen. God bless everybody this afternoon. If you can kindly stand with me, remove your hats as we give honor to God. We thank you, Jesus, for this afternoon. The sun is shining and so are you, God. We're just so grateful for the opportunity to play this wonderful game, Jesus. May you protect everyone that is here on this field, the players, the coaches, the staff, the students, the parents, friends, and family, Jesus. We just thank you and we hope that we honor you today with love and respect. And we play a good game of football, Jesus. We thank you, Father. Amen.
Please join me in welcoming the Judson University and Alumni Choir for the singing of our national anthem. Choir is under the direction of Warren Anderson, Director and Chair of the DeMoss Center for Worship and the Performing Arts.
Beautiful rendition of the national anthem, and we are ready for some football here in just about 8 minutes. Today, the Judson University Eagles, who are 0-2, host the Madonna University Crusaders, a matchup in the Mid-States Football Association. Ryan Sartori on hand alongside Jared Schlensky. Jared, it's a new season. It's a new field. As last year it was Dundee Crown High School, this year Streamwood High School plays host to the Judson Eagles.
Yeah, a lot to be excited for tonight. Your first home game, hoping to get back in the win column after finishing the season strong last season. Judson has had some issues offensively and defensively at times, but a great atmosphere today, beautiful day, and an opportunity to get a win at home in front of a lot of people today.
And we'll get to some of those changes on the offensive side here in just a moment. But, Jared, these are two young programs. Madonna as a program, 1-13. Judson, 4-7 last year, and now looking, both of these teams looking for their first win on the season. They're getting ready to do coin toss there at the 50-yard line. But it's been almost a full calendar year that these two teams have played. It was a victory for Judson last time, but different quarterbacks under center for both programs last year.
Yeah, and both have had flashes of strong play. Christian Miller, mostly the backup last season, threw three touchdowns last week in that loss to St. Francis. And Arthur Bradley, the fourth, four touchdowns last week in that loss to Missouri Baptist. So like you said, new quarterbacks, but both seem to be getting a little bit more and more comfortable, and we'll see how that pans out today here in the first MSFA conference game of the season between the two teams.
Yeah, well, and the difference here is the old quarterback still on the roster for Madonna. The old quarterback for Judson graduated. Aubrey Williams off the program, beyond the program now, and that quarterback from last year, Josh DePaulis, now the second quarterback in this Madonna depth chart. Christian Miller had a couple chances to start games last year. Now he gets a full season to go do his thing. Both these defenses, though, have allowed 50-plus points twice on the season. They'll look to keep the offenses in check, but this could be a really nice get-right game for the Judson offense.
Yeah, you hope so, especially because you're at home and you haven't had a chance to play at home. Obviously, 50 points a game, tough to win ball games when you're allowing that many. We'll see how things pan out. Offenses have struggled at times. Defenses have struggled at times. And for both teams, relatively new programs, it'll be interesting to see because I don't know if anybody knows what to expect.
That's very true. And I will say that this Madonna offensive line has allowed 31 sacks this year. So when you look at some of the new guys on the defensive line for Judson, Troynell Rivers is a freshman from Spring, Texas. He'll have an opportunity to get after Arthur Brantley the fourth today, as well as Bruce Heary, who's a freshman from Janesville, Wisconsin, just north of here.
Yeah, both guys are going to get an opportunity to play a lot. They already have this season. The one guy I'm keeping my eye on is E.J. Glover. He has had some flashes in the past. Last week, 8 tackles, 1 for loss. Let's see if these outside linebackers, defensive linemen, are going to get an opportunity to rush the passer.
Yeah, and it was a gigantic game for Franklin Sayers last week as well on the defensive side. But we are ready for kickoff here. All of this, Jared, and it also is homecoming for the Judson Eagles. So we say hello to all Judson alum watching throughout the world.
Yeah, an exciting game, great atmosphere, new facility. Last mm-hmm. season, it, like you said, it was at Dundee Crown. This year, it's at Streamwood. Either way, awesome. Be excited for it. It's a game that you know, it's for either
kickoff by Thomas Scolino, touchback.
Either way, it's going to be a touchback, and now Judson's defense will go to work at the 25 of Madonna, where they showed some promise last week offensively.
Yep, this is going to be a new look on the defense as they're running a 3-4. Troynell Rivers, Josh Mason, and Bryce Heary on the line. The linebackers, Jared Brooks, E.J. Glover, Chance Crejine, and Jontrell Mitchell. More on the DBs in just a second as Brantley hands off to Nicarius Allgood, who stopped for a short gain of maybe 1.
Josh Mason in on the stop. Last week, 3 tackles. Good job there, expecting the run. And was able to fill his gap and make the play.
Starting DBs for Judson, Ryan Ote, the sophomore from Clinton, Maryland. Cameron Carter, who started last year as a freshman, now a sophomore, finds himself alongside Ote. And the safeties here for Judson, Franklin Sayers and Maitrez Rawls, as this one is handed off quickly to number 5 of Madonna. That's Arthur Brantley, kept on the option there.
Yeah, they brought the man in motion in Novell Chestnut. E.J. Glover thought he had the ball. He didn't. Brantley ended up keeping, and a good thing he did because it would have been a loss of about 5 if he didn't.
Instead, it's 3rd and 10. Ball on the 15. Brantley drops back and looks right. Now fires short, and it's dropped. Looked like all good. Couldn't come up with that one.
Yeah, Zach Bloomer out of the backfield. He had him, too. It was a pretty good throw, just couldn't hang on, maybe a little bit out in front. But give credit to Judson. A couple stops against the run, and you're going to force a 3-and-out on your opening series.
Yep, Judson's defense allowing 51.5 points per game. Nice to get a 3-and-out to start the game. And so we'll see the punter come on for Madonna. This is William Stoyantovich. Averages about 36.5 yards per punt. High snap. Gets it off, nearly blocked by Franklin Sayers. This one going back and is fielded there by number 4 of Judson. That's Ryan Ote. Didn't get any return yards there, but it gives us the Judson offense now. First time for fans to get a good look at Christian Miller.
I like the decision, though, by Ote to return that ball. I think too many times you see returners fair catch to just to play it safe. As long as you can corral the football, you're going to have a chance to return the ball Didn't have much room, but was able to make a little bit of something there.
Yeah, you get those gunners pushing down on you. If they whiff, you do have an opportunity to split the difference and head up the middle and maybe get out to the outside. But here is the Judson offense. Christian Miller on the season, 46% completion percentage. He's alone in the backfield and now a man in motion. That's Brandon Mackey. Hands off to Mackey, coming towards the near sideline. Mackey looking for the edge and gets it for a good gain before he's thrown out of bounds around the 40-yard line. Kelvin Lyleton Jr. on the tackle. And it's a first down for the Eagles. One play, one first down, that'll do it, right?
Yes, it will. Mackey, 7 carries last week. Getting the ball early, you'll see him play some special teams. And I like the up-tempo decision here by the offensive coordinator Jake Lemming, getting to the ball right away.
Two receivers to the near side. And the handoff goes to Mackey up the middle who breaks it. And the handoff goes to Mackey up the middle who breaks a tackle. Now is fighting for extra yardage, getting a push from his O-line. And he'll go down after about a gain of 7 or so.
Really nice push up front so far by Judson on 2 plays from scrimmage. I like what I'm seeing from this offensive line, creating some big holes for Mackey early on.
I think Jaquel Davis is the man in there. So 2 handoffs so far. Miller looking to the sideline for the play call. 2 receivers to the top side. Ovante Vickers, the NCCAA All-American last year near the bottom of your screen, is now coming to the bottom. With him is Nigel Bruce. Miller drops back, looks over the middle, fires, and nearly intercepted. That's Jaquel Davis.
Just a bad read there by Miller. Try to force that ball in the middle of the field, and Davis was able to get 1 hand on it. Not able to get 2 hands, though, and that's the difference between a pick and an incompletion.
And now it's 3rd and about 3. Miller with an offset running back with him in the backfield, and this is going to be a free play. Miller lofts it down the near sideline for Vickers, and that one's going to be picked. It likely will not count, though, as the entire Madonna defensive line was in the neutral zone. We'll see what the official call is. The interception, though, as it stands now, is Cortland Cochran.
Good job there by Miller, recognizing he had a free play. Give credit to the DP, Cortland Cochran, but it's going to be a penalty and new life for Judson.
Yeah, it'll be a first down here as it was an offside by the defense. Head referee today is Heath Powell. Spinning the ones and twos on the field today.
Have had a lot of success running the ball early. Let's see if they go back to it. They went empty 2 plays ago. Let's see what they do here.
Now a quick pass out to the outside, gets it to Vickers. Vickers makes a move, breaks a tackle. Now trying to spin and gain some more, and does. Gain there about 13 yards or so.
There's a reason he's an all-conference receiver. Can do so much, not just catching the ball, but what he can do after the catch makes him dangerous. And a little bit of jaw in between him and Keon Lipscomb Jordan.
Miller now fires the other way, and that one goes through the middle of 2 defenders. Alex Siebens, the freshman from DeKalb, was his target on that one.
Yeah, just another one of those throws that was forced. I like what I'm seeing offensively. It looks like they're getting guys open. Miller just a little inaccurate with a couple of passes here.
Siebens, his senior season at DeKalb last year, 33 catches, 608 yards, 8 touchdowns. He'll be the number 2 here early on in the season aside Ovante Vickers. But this is an air raid offense that was number 1 in passing yards per game last year in the MSFA. As now a handoff goes to Mackey on 2nd down, and he didn't go down there, ladies and gentlemen. Rolled out of a tackle, picks up a gain of about 9.
Will Soley thought he had him. I thought he did too. The ref said he did not touch the ground with his knee or elbow, and give credit to Mackey, recognizing the whistle had never been blown, able to pick up some extra yards.
So it'll be 3rd down and about a yard after an incompletion to Siebens, and that 9-yard pickup there by Mackey. Last year versus Madonna, Mackey 13 attempts, 69 yards. Also had 2 catches and 6 yards for a receiving touchdown last year against the Crusaders. Correction on the game clock. We do have under 11:30 to play in the first. Seventh play of the drive as Bruce goes in motion. Now the fake handoff to Mackey, and Miller's going to keep it himself, and he's met by a host of Crusaders, and the ball comes out. The ball did come out, but the play blown dead by the side judge.
Yeah, I'm curious to see. They haven't signaled it. Now they have. It is going to stay with Judson. I think that was a broken play. I definitely don't think that is how it was designed. And either way, Judson will be able to move the sticks, and they've had some success early on running the football.
Almost primarily sticking with the ground game here in the first drive, Jared. Miller puts Bruce in motion across the formation, fakes the handoff, gives to Mackey. Mackey bounces off the backside of one of his linemen and is dragged down after a gain of 1. That's Carl Ware Jr. in on the stop. Ware, a redshirt sophomore from Detroit, Michigan.
Ware recognized it, off-tackle run, and Mackey was initially hit in the backfield. Give him credit, though. He kept those legs churning and was able to pick up a couple of yards on first down.
So it'll be 2nd and 9 here. Shotgun formation. Miller rolls out looking for Vickers. Tries to get it off, but he's hit as he throws, and that one will fall incomplete. Big number 95, Amond Price, gets in there.
Yeah, Amond Price delivered a licking there on Miller. He was just lucky to get it off and have it fall to the ground, because in a situation like this, the last thing you want to do is take a sack, set up 3rd and long. You still have 3rd and manageable with the incompletion.
So now it's 3rd down and 9. Judson in the red zone. Miller, this will be a free play as well. Miller tries to get it to Siebens, and that one bounces off his hands and incomplete.
I thought someone jumped too, Ryan, but I don't see a flag. And I'm not convinced Tomas Colino is going to kick from here. He did make a 34-yarder last week. It would be 47 yards from here.
He was warming up and hitting about 45 yarders, and they will go for it on 4th here, Jared. 4th and 9.
Yeah, I think it's the right decision to go for it here if you're Coach Poplasek.
Miller looking for clarification. Takes the snap. Looks right. Vickers running a slant. He was looking for him, but he'll go down. The Crusaders get home.
Yeah, good job there getting pressure on 4th and long. Will Solly in there along with Will Fenema. And, well, a good first drive, but it doesn't end up with points. Give credit to Madonna. Ben, don't break. And now their offense is going to get a chance to go back on the field.
It looked like Nash Phillips got in there, as well as some defensive linemen as well. And so the 11-play drive results in no points for Judson. And they flip sides here. Arthur Brantley and crew ready to come back onto the field.
And like I said, we talked about in the pregame, both quarterbacks, strong performances last week. So far, both have played okay. Let's see if they can be a little more crisp now.
Brantley
here on their second series.
Drops back and delivers a pass to Novell Chestnut on the season. 9 catches, 241 yards, touchdown. Gain of about 5 yards there.
Good pickup on first down. Just take what the defense gives you. Like we said, Arthur Brantley is a dual-threat quarterback.
Handoff there goes to the running back. Looks like Allgood. He is their number one, Nicarius Allgood, but they will run a multitude of different guys out there, and that was Allgood emerging from the pile, the freshman from Colorado Springs, Colorado.
Been a busy day early on for Josh Mason, a couple of tackles right near the line of scrimmage, and this Judson team has done a pretty good job against the run. Let's see what defensive coordinator Pat Fitzpatrick draws up here on 3rd down.
So 3rd and 3. As Brantley looks and fires for his number one, Devontae Garrett, and that one will fall incomplete. And it'll be another 3 and out for Madonna's offense.
Good job defensively. Good coverage on the back end by Judson DB Dominique Carter, Just a simple corner out there by the receiver Devontae Garrett, and unable to hook up with his quarterback Brantley. This Judson team is going to force another punt.
And brings back William Stoyanovich. Kicks a spiral and a good one. Real deep inside the 10-yard line, and it'll roll actually all the way to the goal line. What a punt by William Stoyanovich for the Brand.
I want to know if that ball touched the end line. If it did, Judson will be at the 20. This is pretty big. I'm not convinced Madonna picked it up in time.
We'll see. We're waiting for that official call down there. It's either on the one or a touchback. The two officials down there on the goal line having a conversation about it, but I don't know that this will be overturned.
Yeah, they're going to spot it at the one. Give credit to the punter there in William Stoyanovich. He got a lot under that one and threw off Ryan Ote big time.
So after an 11-play drive for the Judson offense in their first drive, now they start with their heels on the goal line. First and 10. Miller. Hands off. Mackey breaks a tackle, fighting for extra yards. And now he's going to be brought down at about the 2 or 3 yard line down there.
Yeah, forward progress should give him at least the 2 or 3. Good job there by Nigel Bruce, just getting something. And now here on second down, you got a little bit more breathing room as you're not backed up inside the one.
Second down makes you feel like maybe you can get a pass off here, but typically this is a running situation, and it looks like Madonna knows that as they load the box. Miller takes a snap, looks for Vickers, gets it to Vickers. Might be enough for a first down, if not just shy a yard.
Nice tackle by Madonna cornerback Cortland Cochran, playing a little bit off coverage. Good recognition, though, too, by Christian Miller, just getting him to the ball in the hands of Vickers on the quick hitch route.
And now 3rd and 3. Ball on the 10-yard line. Two receivers to the high side. Jordan West, Alex Sebens, Avante Vickers by himself on the near side. Miller takes a snap. Looks for West. West makes the catch, and that'll be a first down.
Good job there by Jordan West, recognizing where the first down was, getting there. An even better job of Christian Miller having patience, not getting rid of that ball too soon, and hitting his man for a first down.
So now on first down, the Eagles have been really relying on their run game here on first down. See if they stick with that here. Miller looks for clarification. Christian Miller from San Antonio, Texas. It's funny that the Eagles carry two quarterbacks on the two deep today, both from San Antonio, Texas. I'm sure they've played one another at least a couple times during their high school careers as Miller fires to the far sideline. Alex Sebens, the freshman from DeKalb, makes the catch.
Good job there by Christian Miller, recognizing the DBs playing off a little bit, getting these passes off in plenty of time and allowing his receivers to do a little bit after the catch.
Judson, new offensive line going from center, right guard, right tackle, the only holdovers from last year, Derek DeVries, Tyler Silverstrand. Miller now turns and hands to Mackey. Mackey emerges through the line and is at the bottom of that pile over there.
It might have come out.
Sounded like excitement from the Madonna sideline, but possession remains with Judson.
Yeah, I think it is going to stay here with Judson. Good balance. I really like the game plan so far from OC Jake Lemming, mixing in run and pass, just taking what the defense gives you and able to pick up another first down.
Judson currently moving the ball at will on offense. Bruce comes across the middle with a little motion. Mackey breaks through the line for a big pickup and is brought down by a host of Crusaders.
That was all set up by the misdirection. You bring the man in motion in the receiver, Jontrell Mitchell. Instead, it goes up the middle to the running back, Mackey, and able to move the sticks.
And it looks like Carl Ware in there on the tackle. Motion again with Bruce. Fake handoff. It goes to Mackey. Mackey with a gain of about 5.
Yeah, they like that fake jet sweep. I think it's a read play, so Miller does have the option to give it to Nigel Bruce, but instead likes what Mackey's been able to do between the tackles, and another strong pickup on first down.
So now second down and about 5, and this drive did start on the 1 yard line, about 6 or 7 plays into it. And they're already across the 50-yard line for the second time today as an offense. Under 5 minutes to play, we're knotted at 0. Miller with a quick fire to Siebens on the far side. This will go for a first down. Tackled there by Keon Jordan. Jordan, a redshirt sophomore from Michigan.
Very nice job by Siebens, being able to do a little bit after the catch. Give credit to Christian Miller. He's not forcing things. He's taking what the defense is giving him, and as a result, we've got 4 first downs on this series.
Vontae Vickers sticks to the bottom of the screen here. Jordan West in the slot. Siebens alone at the top. That Alex Siebens, a 4.7 40 time coming out of high school. Shuttle time of about 4.3. So quick and agile, and the ball goes to him again as he breaks a tackle, and he gets to show off some speed as this one goes for a gain of about 15.
Yeah, that one was a little bit of a shorter hitch route. Usually we've seen it about 3 or 4 yards. That was closer to 2 yards, and he was able to break free from Keon Lipscomb Jordan and pick up a first down.
Keeping things kind of close to the line in the passing game here early on. 5th first down of the drive. Knocking on the red zone. Miller with a pump fake now goes towards Siebens on the left side, and that one was ill-advised. Siebens hadn't yet turned his head around. It looks like maybe Cortland Cochran over there.
Yeah, he just got rid of that one a little bit too soon. Didn't allow the play to fully develop, but give credit to Nico Allgood on the outside sticking with the receiver Siebens.
Christian Miller played in 5 games last year for Judson, so he's still figuring some things out under center, or at least in the shotgun, as most plays have been run so far. Here's a handoff to Mackey, and this one will go for good yards on second down, pickup of about 3.
Yeah, Brandon Mackey's been fun to watch early on, very decisive with his cuts, not dancing around in the backfield, 1 cut downhill, and has done a good job of finding yards after initially getting hit.
3.5 minutes to play in the first. Judson in the red zone once again. 2 drives, 2 red zone trips. They're 0 for 1 so far. As now Miller moving, throws it to Vickers a little low, and they say he caught it right around the 15-yard line, maybe the 16.
Man, that's a really tough catch there, too. You're not going to see many catches like that. The ball was a little bit underthrown. I'm not sure if that's where he wanted to put it, but either way, Vickers able to haul it in. And a good job again of moving the sticks, taking what the defense gives you.
Now this is a more manageable fourth down than it was on the first drive, but still, Miller has a chance to extend this drive or end it with no points at all. Madonna's defense has jumped a couple times already, but they won't try for the hard count. Instead, they hand to Mackey. Mackey fighting for more towards the goal line. It's a touchdown! Judson strikes first with their first rushing touchdown of the season.
You talk about just willing your way into the end zone. Mackey near the goal line took about 3 guys with him and able to just lower his shoulder, keep the legs moving for 6, and a good start for Judson. First time they've had a lead at any point so far this season.
And they did it by running the ball down an opposing team's throat, something that they haven't done extremely well so far, but they've stuck to it. 70 attempts coming into today's game, leading to 161 yards on the ground. It's certainly going to increase the yards per game today, as the extra point is up and good. The kicker this year, Thomas Colino, a transfer from Slippery Rock University, but from Sao Paulo, Brazil. So it's a 7-0 lead for the Eagles. We'll take a quick break and be right back with you. Eagles lead 7-0.
Yeah, you're fine.
And we're back here from Millennium Stadium in Streamwood, Illinois, the host for the 2022 season for your Judson Eagles. It's homecoming, and they have struck first, a 16-yard touchdown on the ground for Brandon Mackey, the first rushing touchdown of the year for Judson. And now the man who converted on the extra point, Thomas Colino, comes back out to break open action once more.
Very nice second series there from the Judson offense. First series they were able to move the ball efficiently to. Got stopped on fourth down. The balance, I think, of the run and the pass so far has really been the difference in this one. Madonna offensively, they've been able to get something on second down, but have really struggled on first down. Let's see what they do here on their third offensive series.
Kind of a squib kick here as it's fallen on. And Madonna will start their drive at the 25-yard line. Man falling on that one was Cole Rosnow from Marion, Wisconsin. Rosnow a freshman. But it brings back Arthur Brantley, and so far this offense for Madonna has gone three and out twice. Arthur Brantley, new to the Madonna program this year. Technically his third school, as he started a freshman at Iowa Central Community College. As he hands the ball off, no, keeps it and throws to the far side. One move made and a big tackle laid on the completion on first down, a gain of about 2 yards.
Good tackle by Trey Sayers, who had a big week last week. Does a little bit of everything. We'll do some returning. We'll punt, play safety. And Arthur Brantley, good job there on the RPO going to the outside.
Brantley, just to finish that note, second school was Edward Waters College, a D2 school in Jacksonville, Florida. As he comes this way, and the boom is laid on Devonta Garrett.
E.J. Glover, we talked about him in the pregame. I don't think they're going to give him the forced fumble. I think it's just going to be an incomplete pass. But great anticipation and a delivery of a big hit there.
A textbook tackle by the sophomore from Atlanta, Georgia. That one will go definitely on his highlight tape. A big hit there. Now it's third down and long. About 8 yards to go for the Madonna offense. Man in motion is Garrett. Brantley drops back. Didn't like his first read. Now will try to pick it up with his legs and will. First down and more. Maybe a gain of about 14 yards.
Yeah, he's got really long strides and an excellent job there of just using those strides to take advantage of the open space following the broken play. Zone coverage is going to leave some holes when the quarterback escapes, and he was able to move the sticks.
Yeah, he's certainly a running quarterback. Can throw the ball as well, obviously, or else they wouldn't have him under center. But 24 attempts, 136 yards last week against Northwoods as he keeps again here, going off the far side. And he almost gets the edge, but is shoved out of bounds by Cameron Carter.
Yeah, nice job again by Brantley. You pick up the first down with your legs on the previous play. What do? You go to the option. He keeps, has room on the outside, and is able to pick up another first down.
So with no first downs in the first two drives, now they have two consecutive first downs. Receivers to either side of the formation. Brantley in the shotgun with Allgood to his left, and he will hand off to Nicarius Allgood here, and the ball comes out.
Sure did. Came out a little late. I think it was E.J. Glover again.
And it's Judson's football.
Yeah, Glover forced it. Josh Mason recovered it. And these two guys were starters a year ago, having an impact early on in this game.
The defense really found itself last year too, Jared. We watched this whole unit grow throughout that first season that Judson had last year, and it looks like things are starting to carry over here in season number two of the Patton Fitzpatrick side of the football. That's the defensive coordinator for Judson, Patton Fitzpatrick, in his second year coordinating the Eagle defense.
Yeah, nice job early on by this defense, 2 3-and-outs, and now you force a fumble, and with momentum on your side, let's see what the offense can do, able to punch it in on their last series.
The offense starts at their own 45. Handoff goes to Mackey. This one picks up a gain of about 4.
Haven't seen the spin move much today from either team, and Mackey able to spin forward for a couple of extra yards.
We are under a minute here to play. Approaching the first quarter break. Miller drops back, looks over the middle, gives it to Vickers, who makes a nice catch on the slant route. Makes a cut, upfield, looking for the sideline. He'll dance out of bounds. What a catch by Vickers. What a run by Vickers.
Yeah, a little bit behind him, but Vickers able to slow his momentum down and make the play. Nice job there, and able to pick up another first down. They've got a little connection here, these two, early on today.
And that's the guy you got to rely on. Again, a 2021 NCCAA All-American, and he was an NAIA Honorable Mention All-American. And the first quarter comes to a close. 7-0 your score. Eagles leading the Crusaders. We'll take a quick break and be right back. For the start of the second quarter, Judson leads 7-0. They flip the field and will head towards the other end zone now. First down and 10 as we resume play. Two receivers to either side of the formation. Handoff goes to Mackey. Mackey follows the man who was in motion, looked like maybe Mykeen Chandler. Gets a good pickup there on first down. It'll be second down. Second down and 7.
Yeah, Will Solly in on the stop for Madonna. This has been an efficient offense early on, 163 yards, and we're just at the start of the second quarter, 79 yards through the air. This is a balanced offense, and I don't think you could be much more happy if you're Coach Poplazek.
And an offense that leaned heavily on the pass last year, if it can become more balanced, there's a shot over the middle, it's incomplete.
Yeah, he had his man too. Miller just put a little bit too much air on it. A really nice job by the Madonna safety on the play. That was Keon Lipscomb Jordan of not lowering his crown of the helmet, using his shoulder to deliver the hit. Definitely a clean hit. And is going to bring up third down.
Looked like it might have been Keonta Fox going down the seam, but now on third down, Miller in motion, and he will be brought down. A big third down sack there. That looked to be Owen Aldridge to get in there first, but was brought down by about three Madonna defenders.
Yeah, it was. Like you said, you got it right right there. A difficult situation if you're Judson. You're able to move the football, and unfortunately, a sack on third down is going to force you to punt here.
Yeah, much too much ground to pick up for an offense. It would be fourth and 12. Instead, they'll send William Stojanovic on for his first punt. Or excuse me, this is Thomas Colino, pardon me, as the punt lands at the 10 and rolls out of bounds around the 9-yard line. The Crusaders, who've had trouble moving the ball so far, will have to start with their backs on the shadow of their own goal line.
I think the story right now has been the Judson defense, 2-3 and outs, and then a forced fumble. They have not allowed a whole lot so far today against a Madonna team that put up 37 points last week. So, obviously there's a lot of time left, but in terms of an early start, I think you got to be pretty darn happy if you're Coach Poplazek.
Yeah, on both sides of the football. Again, the Judson team did face some pretty formidable opponents. They had St. Francis of Indiana last week, and they're always a good program. The run goes to the near side and brought down there for a short gain. It is all good.
I like what I've seen from the defense, especially up front. Josh Mason has been very effective early on. The question is, can they sustain it? This is then your first home game. You never know what to expect. Sometimes maybe you almost come up a little bit too fired up, but they've kept their cool. They've stayed calm, and right now they are playing lights-out football.
Second down and long, man in motion. Devonta Garrett, Brantley, drops back, and he's knocked down. Huge sack there.
E.J. Glover again as the ball came out. Let's see if they rule this a safety.
Mercy.
Yeah, he took a good lick in there, and we've seen a couple early hits from this defensive front, especially E.J. Glover. He can play, and he's showing it right now.
E.J. Glover, the man out of a cannon on that last play. Arthur Brantley still down on the ground. We'll take a quick break as they sort out the injury. We come back as Arthur Brantley is still being tended to on the field. But, Jared, a situation like that where you see a blindside hit, you have to think of maybe a stunt or something run there by E.J. Glover to get past the left tackle, Horace Ewer.
Yeah, a really explosive hit by E.J. Glover. Brantley still being attended to. You hate to see anybody get hurt. And, we'll just have to wait and see. Hopefully he's okay and hopefully he can return as he's now up to his feet. But either way, you've got to be really pleased if you're Judson defensive coordinator Patton Fitzpatrick. Your team's done a good job against the pass. They've done a solid job against the run. And they forced a turnover too today. So you've got to be pretty happy early on in this one.
So as Arthur Brantley exits, we now see Josh DePaulis at quarterback.
And
it is third down and long here for the Crusaders. DePaulis, a sophomore, redshirt sophomore from Flat Rock, Michigan, was the starter last year, played against Judson, and threw for 210 yards and a touchdown in that game a year ago.
I'm not sure what you do here. You might just hand it off. Tough coming into a situation like this, but no, they're going to give it a go.
Yeah, DePaulis drops back, sees nobody, throws it in the vicinity of his closest receiver. And that is a concession right there, where as a team, now you go back to the sideline and try to figure out what your game plan looks like.
Yeah, it looks like they're just trying to set up a screen with Nico Allgood. It wasn't there. Good job by DePaulis. Just coming into the game, first pass. Throw it in the ground. Can't take a sack. And now you got to punt the football and see if your defense can get another stop.
We talk about how happy Dan Poplazic and Patton Fitzpatrick must be in this situation, but man, if you're the head coach of Madonna, Herb Haygood, you're really not happy with four unsuccessful drives to start this play as the punt from Stojanovic goes out of bounds.
Yeah, I think there's been some positives. The previous series, you were able to pick up some yards with your quarterback. Your defense has kept you in this game, and again, we're not even halfway through the second quarter, so there's still a ton of time. Now let's see if Judson can put together another good drive. So far today, they've moved the ball, but only one touchdown so far. Let's see what they have in store here.
12-10 left in the half. Judson leads by 7. Excellent field position here to try to add some points. They will be looking, obviously, to push this ball into the end zone. Two receivers to either side of the set. Here's Christian Miller as he brings Mackey up in the formation. Mackey's going to pick, supposed to pick up that edge blocker there. As Miller goes down hard, the pass completed to Vickers, who marches forward for a gain of about 12.
Yeah, and Christian Miller had to get rid of it quickly. He did, and Vickers, after the catch, that's where he's really been most effective today. Ovante Vickers now with 4 catches.
You see Dakari Ferguson check in on the far side of your screen. Ferguson and Vickers were a nightmare duo for defenses last year. As Ferguson comes across the formation, the handoff goes to Mackey. He's brought down in the backfield.
Really nice job by Will Solly. He was the one that delivered the hit on Miller on the previous play. This time he goes sideline to sideline and gets the stop right near the line of scrimmage.
As we talk about Dakari Ferguson, have to mention he was the man last year who caught the first touchdown in program history. Of course, like we said, him and Vickers just absolutely tore up opposing defenses last year. Miller checking for clarification. He's got 2 men low, 1 man high. Sends Damon Mueller in motion to the left. Now brings Ferguson the other way. The handoff goes to Mackey, who cuts through the middle of the line yet again for a nice big gain on second down.
Yeah, give credit to Christian Miller. These are all read plays. Man in motion was Dakari Ferguson, but likes to give it to Mackey, and Mackey so far has had a heck of a day early on. And once again, another first down on the ground. 75 yards and just 10 carries for Mackey now.
Having a tremendous day is the running back for the Eagles, as another jump there on the defensive line. No snap, so they get back. And we're ready again for third down and about 5. Quick pass out to Siebens. This one broken up.
Maybe the best defensive play so far today by
Julian
DB
Adams.
Julian Adams. Played off coverage, recognized Miller with the eyes that he was going to come there quickly and just jumped the route. Not able to pick it, but was able to break up the pass and bring up fourth down.
Dan Poplazic and OC Jake Lemming are going to leave the offense on the field here as the ball sits on about the 28-yard line. Miller takes a snap, looks over the middle, now to the left for Siebens. This ball's overthrown and incomplete.
And he had him too. Siebens had a step on his man. Miller just put it a little bit too far to the sideline, and as a result, a turnover on downs. And like I said, we didn't really know what to expect. Both teams have given up a lot of points and at times have struggled to score, but today the defense have come through early on in this one.
Yeah, even Madonna's defense has really showed up strong here early on, forcing 2 turnovers on downs and a punt. And so now they trot back onto the field. Again, this is a new quarterback we're seeing, Josh DePaulis, who started last year, which was Madonna's technically first full year as a football program. He keeps and is hit hard in the backfield.
Yeah, you talk about a good job up front today by this defensive line, and we haven't really talked much about the defensive backs, but that was a nice job by Cameron Carter, recognizing the run and making the play.
Yeah, the defensive backs are being coached this year by former NFL vet Quinton Demps, who spent 9 years in the league with Houston and Chicago and some other teams as well, and this is a secondary that's performing well, namely Franklin Sayers, who's having just a standout year so far in 2 games. DePaulis fires over the middle on a slant. This one goes to Chestnut. Chestnut pushed out of bounds by the aforementioned Franklin Sayers.
Yeah, nice job there on the pitch and catch. Just a little bit of a crossing route from Novell Chestnut and able to show his speed following the catch. Both teams now trying to get their receivers the ball via quick passes and let these guys show the case their athleticism after the catch.
Chestnut, one of those small body receivers that'll absolutely burn you with his speed if you let him into the open field like he had on that last play. He ran a slant. Under 9 to go. First down and 10. Handoff here goes to Spencer Rivera, and he's brought down a yard in the backfield.
Yeah, good job by Glover and Carter getting there. This team has shown great speed early on defensively. It's going to be tough for Madonna to move the ball on the ground. I think your best way, if you're Madonna, is going to have to try through the air.
And will they have enough time to get the ball off through the air is kind of the question. We saw already Arthur Brantley, who started this game, was dropped back and looking for something over the middle, and he didn't have that ball in his hands longer than 4 seconds before he got absolutely popped by E.J. Glover. DePaulis now drops back, scans, and he goes down.
Been a busy day today for this defensive line. They set up there with the stunt, freed up Dontrell Mitchell, and Mitchell able to get to the quarterback. This has been a very efficient pass rush today for Judson, maybe the best they've played all season.
And just as a reminder, this is an offensive line that gives up a ton of sacks, 31 on the year, and already 4 or 5 today, Jared.
Yeah, and last week was rough for Madonna. Madonna last week allowed 12 sacks, and today they've been sacked about 4 times.
3rd and 15, DePaula steps up, fires over the middle, and that one falls incomplete. Devontae Garrett was the intended target.
Yeah, and he had to get rid of it a little bit earlier than he wanted to, and that was the difference in the incompletion versus the completion. And Judson defensively continues to wreak havoc. 4 sacks, and let's see what Madonna elects to do here on 4th down.
They have brought on their punter yet again. This will be the 5th drive in a row that's resulted in either a punt or a fumble. Franklin Sayers nearly got in there as it's a bad punt that rolls.
And picked up, risky there to pick it up with Madonna coming downhill, but a good job of securing the football by Ryan Ote.
Ote fielding basically a ground ball to shortstop right there. Gave him a nice little Sunday hop on a Saturday.
Yeah, how about it? Risky though, nonetheless. And, both defenses have played well. Couple of sacks for each defensive line. The question is, when these offenses move the ball, can they finish a drive? They've really struggled doing that so far today.
So 1st and 10, 5th drive of the game for Christian Miller and company as he turns and hands off to Nigel Bruce, who's got a little room. Bruce with a burst, and he's brought down around the 46-yard line.
Well, I'll tell you what right there. Madonna's Owen Aldrich just saved a touchdown. Nigel Bruce had passed everybody except him, and that was the difference between 6 and a long gain.
I think he had the beat on Kelvin Lyleton as well, who was the safety coming down to help stop that. He was the last man, but great tackle there. And now a 1st down near the 50-yard line for the Eagles. Miller, quick pass, gets it to Ferguson. Dakari Ferguson making a move, makes another move. There he goes. Ferguson's going to beat them all. Touchdown, Eagles.
You talk about speed, and that's what you saw from Ferguson.
Dakari Ferguson with the first passing touchdown of the day. 2nd score for the Eagles. It's 13-0.
Excellent job there by Ferguson, using his speed after the catch. We've seen Vickers for the most part. Now it's Ferguson getting involved, and now a 2-score lead.
It was about a 54-yard completion. Here comes Colino for the extra point, 1 for 1 today. If you didn't hear it earlier, I'll say it again. Colino from Sao Paulo, Brazil. Kicks the football through the uprights, and we've got a 14-0 game with 6:37 remaining here in the 2nd quarter. Back in a minute. Thank you. Back to resume play. Thomas Colino just hit the extra point. Now set to send it deep.
Well, I think you got to be pretty pleased if you're Coach Poplizek. You've done a good job defensively of getting pressure on the quarterback, and offensively, you haven't turned the football over. You've had a good balance of running the ball and throwing the football, and now you just want your team to not take your foot off the gas. This game's far from over. Continue to be aggressive.
Well, you've had 50 points hung on you in two consecutive weeks. You want to hang a 50-burger of your own if you're the Eagles, and so I don't suspect any let-up from this team. Is Colino sends it deep. Deshaun Hayes, Jacob Ireland, the deep man, doesn't go as far as you'd expect it to, but it's fielded there by Deshaun Hayes, and he's tackled around the 30-yard line, and that'll bring back the Crusader offense.
And let's see who goes out at quarterback. We saw Arthur Brantley the fourth get hurt early on. Josh DePaulis was in there for the previous series. Don't want to speculate on an injury, but let's wait and see exactly who is playing quarterback.
Well, we know who's coaching both teams, and how about we take a quick look at Herb Haygood, who's in his third year coaching this Crusader team, has spent time around a lot of different programs, as we see DePaulis back in the shotgun for the Crusaders. Get to his resume after this play, as DePaulis keeps and is looking deep, and he's going to go down.
Yeah, you got to get rid of that ball if you're DePaulis. Give credit, though, to Clifton Jimerson finishing the play and getting the sack. That's the third sack now today for this Judson defense.
Outside the tackle box, you just got to let that one loose. Instead, it goes as a loss of about 10 yards.
Yeah, you're outside the pocket. All you got to do is get the ball to the line of scrimmage.
So Clifton Jimerson gets home for his first sack of the year. But on the note of Herb Haygood, has spent time all over the state of Michigan. You look at, he was an assistant strength coach at Michigan State, a wide receiver coach and special teams coach at Olivet College and Saginaw Valley State University. Also was an offensive intern at Miami University. He spent the last 4 years with the Madonna program, both as a coordinator, and he took over as head coach in 2020. But this is a guy that spent some time in the NFL as well, Jared. It was a 2022 draft pick in the fifth round by Denver and played for Indianapolis and Kansas City as a return man.
So basically you're telling me he's been around for a while, right?
Oh, yeah.
He's done a little bit of everything, offense, defense, special teams, strength and conditioning. Madonna's in good hands. I know, you know, things haven't gone well for them right now, but give it time. You know, Rome wasn't built in a day, as they say.
That's right.
This program, you know, is in good hands.
Was known as a top recruiter in the MAC conference from 2014 to 2019. Was a runner-up for the MAC Recruiter of the Year in 2016. As this is looks to be Arthur Brantley back in the game. He throws over the middle. A great catch there by Novell Chestnut. And Chestnut still on his feet at the 40. The ball comes out. It's recovered by Judson.
Wow, that's a tough one. Chestnut does a ton of weaving and making guys miss. And then you pick up a fumble, and I think it was Jontrell Mitchell who picked it up. That's a tough break. Best play of the day offensively, and it ends in a fumble recovered by the defense. Great job by Judson.
A huge chunk there on what would have been a third down and extremely long for Madonna. Instead, you see that happen a lot with shifty receivers, right? They get the ball, they start jumping around, they make a bunch of cuts, and sometimes it's just best to go down. But in a game like this where you don't know who's going to miss a tackle, who might whiff, and whose arms you might break through, you can't blame them for doing it, but sometimes it's best to just take what you got and go down. Here comes Christian Miller again, a quick pass to the outside. Vickers can't corral this one with the left hand.
Yeah, these DBs are starting to come up a step or two, and a good job there on the outside by Cortland Cochran, not being fooled and not allowing that hitch route to be completed.
Christian Miller after the 54-yard completion to Ferguson, now up over 100 yards on the day passing. He's 10 for 19, 138 and a touchdown. Second down and 10. Miller turns and hands to Mackey. Mackey with a big run here, a gain of about 11. Here, watching him warm up earlier today You did have Colino making from about 45 out. The ball is located right now on the 30, so kind of on the cusp of his range. But either way, you're seeing an attempt at points here nonetheless.
Yeah, it'd be pretty risky if you put the field goal off. The last thing you want is a block and a scoop and a score. I think the best thing here is probably a Hail Mary. Keep a back in the backfield to give you an extra blocker. Keep a tight end on the line of scrimmage just to give your quarterback some time.
It is 14-0 as we're getting ready to head into halftime here in Streamwood. Eagles holding a commanding lead. Every drive so far this quarter for Madonna's offense has resulted in either a punt or a turnover, a fumble, and or two fumbles rather so far by ball carriers for the Crusaders. No turnovers at this point for Judson as we get ready to head into halftime. Still waiting to see which unit comes out onto the field. It looks like Miller will break huddle with Dan Poplazek, and this is going to be a shot at the end zone here, Jared.
I would assume so, unless maybe try a hook and ladder.
Maybe the backyard shenanigans play.
You've got Vickers, who's a wide target, and, I'm a little surprised not to see Ferguson is out there. He's
Miller
in the
takes
slot.
Takes a snap. He's going to fire towards Vickers in the end zone, and it is incomplete.
Yeah, I like the ball. Maybe would have liked to have seen it get a little bit higher, but with pressure coming, a good job of just giving him a chance at throwing it up there.
So the first half comes to an end, and Judson has a 14-0 lead. The big play of the half, a 46-yard completion from Christian Miller to Dakari Ferguson. That was the second touchdown of the afternoon for the Judson offense, and that has them with that 14-0 lead. We head to half. We'll be back with more Judson Eagle football.
Thank you. $6 million for four camps, started an annual gala generating over $600,000 in new revenue across 5 years, and increased the organization's average annual operating budget by 50%. Josh Pucci graduated from Judson in 2002 with a degree in visual communications. Josh founded the Gucci Institute with his father in 2004 in Elgin to promote the art of wood sculpture around the world. Josh is a three-time world champion wood sculptor and art instructor who has worked with students in over 25 states across the country. Lori Heiselman graduated in 1993 with a degree in psychology. Today, she owns Biscuit Media Group, boutique media group that exists to shine a spotlight on startup companies, independent filmmakers, musicians, and creatives working with the likes of Collide Media Group, Frontgate, Revelation Media, Curb Records, EMI, Pixar, Walden Media, Lionsgate, and Roadside Attractions. And Steve Van Osdale graduated in 1998 with a degree in biology. He went on to get his Doctor of Chiropractic degree in 1993, and opened his own practice, Boston Chiropractic. He has been the owner of Lubbock Integrated Medical Institute for more than 7 years, using a multidisciplinary model approach to healthcare. In 2019, Steve was named Doctor of the Year by Texas Chiropractic Association. The athletic department honored four former scholar athletes for their accomplishments that they conducted into the Judson University Sports Hall of Fame. Musa Nkamazama, men's soccer class of 1998, a member of a conference championship and NCCAA national championship team, Musa earned NCCAA All-American honors as well as being named NCCAA National Tournament Player of the Year. Landon Skinner,
men's basketball class of 2012. A key leader of the 2009-2010 CCAC championship team, Landon was a four-time CCAC all-conference athlete, was named
Freshman of the Year, and earned NCCAA All-American honors. He currently ranks second all-time in points, as well as being top five in several Judson men's basketball record categories. Lana Rasmussen-Smith, women's volleyball class of 1998. Leading her team to back-to-back NAIA regional championships, Lana earned CCAC All-Conference and NCCAA All-Region honors. She was named Judson University's 1998 Female Athlete of the Year and currently sits in the top 10 in two women's volleyball statistical categories. Matt McHenry, baseball class of 2012, a member of the 2012 NAIA tournament team, Matt earned CCAC All-Conference honors. He was named Judson University's 2012 Male Athlete of the Year and currently sits in the top 10 in several single-season record categories. Congratulations to the newest members of the Judson Athletics Hall of Fame. The Alumnus of the Year Award is given to recognize alumni who have made significant contributions to the church and society, who are decisive leaders and effective ambassadors for Christ. Recognized this weekend as Alumnus of the Year was Pastor Patrick Parks from the class of 2019, who graduated with a degree in Christian Ministries. Reverend Parks is the ninth pastor of the historic Second Baptist Church of Elgin since its founding in 1866. He served 6 years in the U.S. Army and worked for the United Postal Service for 32 years before answering the Lord's call to preach the gospel. While completing his degree at Judson, he had the opportunity to complete an internship under the leadership and direction of Reverend Dr. Nathaniel Edmond, his predecessor. Reverend Parks continues to move the mission of Second Baptist Church forward by building meaningful partnerships with the Food for Greater Elgin and Willow Creek Community Church Mobile Food Pantry to assist families who have been adversely affected due to the coronavirus pandemic. The Family Legacy Award is given to families of alumni, trustees, faculty, and or staff for their dedication and service to Judson University over several generations. Reverend Gary and Janie Nelson family is this year's recipient. Gary served as the assistant pastor at First Baptist Church of Elgin with Pastor Willis Reed, where he first came in contact with Judson students. Eventually, he became the pastor of Cherry Hills Family Church in Springfield, Illinois. Janie has been involved with Judson through the Friends of Judson. Together, they have been married for 57 years and are parents of three Judson alumni. Reverend Jeff Nelson from the class of 1983, who serves as the pastor of Cherry Hills Family Church today. Dr. Scott Nelson from the class of 1985, who is a medical missionary to the Philippines. And Kristen Nelson Tinch from the class of 1987. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give all of these Judson Eagles a big round of applause. We also take time to recognize beloved Judson University and faculty athletic representative, Dr. Jack Groppel. On Wednesday, Dr. Groppel was inducted into the United States Professional Tennis Association Hall of Fame. Dr. Groppel is an internationally recognized authority and pioneer in the science of human performance. His research has included performance analysis of over 25 sports, having successfully worked with numerous world-class athletes. His scientific findings have appeared in numerous peer-reviewed journals, and he has also served as an instruction editor to Tennis Magazine and had a column entitled Ask the Professor in USPTA's Advantage Magazine that ran for 25 years. As a motivating and highly entertaining speaker, Dr. Groppel has spoken at thousands of functions on six continents for many different audiences. Dr. Groppel is a mentor to countless students and staff at Judson. He has reimagined the role of faculty athletics representative, started the Scholar Athlete Advisory Committee, and serves as a liaison between faculty and athletics. More importantly, Dr. Groppel serves as a tremendous role model in resources to the students, coaches, his peers, and the university in general. Thank you, Dr. Groppel, and congratulations on your induction into the United States Professional Tennis Association Hall of Fame. Please welcome Judson University's Dean of Student Life and Leadership, Aubrey Flickema, to introduce our homecoming court.
Hey everybody, how's it going? How are we feeling tonight, today, this afternoon? Doing good. All right, well, my name is Aubrey Flickema. I am the Dean of Student Life and Leadership here at Judson University, and I have the utmost honor and privilege to announce to you, our community, the 2022-23 Homecoming Corps. Are we ready? Yeah. Okay, so I want to hear you guys just cheer as loud as you can for these folks. All right, so our freshmen, queen and king, they are Catherine Hegewald and Milo Snyder. Our sophomore queen and king are Sydney Elder and Gordon Thompson. Our junior queen and king are Emma Garrett and Trey Lehman. And our senior queen and king are Hannah Womack and PJ Nkalangango. Let's give these guys one more big round of applause.
let's welcome back to the field your Judson University Eagles.
Yeah, Judson did a great job defensively. That was the difference in the first half.
It's raffle time again, Eagles. Blue crew and raffle ticket holders, pull out your tickets as we read the winning number. 270051. That's 270051. Please come to the press box to claim your prize.
Turned around on a fumble, but that guy's shifty.
He sure is, and speed is essential at the college level. It's essential at any level, obviously, but we've seen flashes of good speed from both teams, but the difference, and again, I hate to sound like a broken record, has been the defensive line play of Judson. They haven't allowed positive rushing yards. They have four sacks. Josh Mason was really explosive early on, and then it was Jontrell Mitchell and EJ Glover contributing late in the second quarter. So if Madonna does not clean things up front, they're probably going to fall to 0-5.
And all signs kind of tell you that they might not clean things up on the line, but how does that look schematically for an offense when you know your offensive line isn't going to do a ton for you as a quarterback? How do you then start to counter that?
You know, that's a great question, and I think it's a question that I'm not sure Herb Haygood can even answer. Maybe take some shots down the field. Arthur Brantley IV had some good success running the football. Those were on mostly designed pass plays. We'll see if they come out Madonna using Brantley, because again, obviously he got hurt earlier in the game. You don't want to put too much of the responsibility on him, but if they don't get something going offensively and get it going early, it could be a long day for Madonna.
Most definitely. We are just about ready for kickoff here in the second half. Catch you up on the scoring plays. Second drive of the game for Judson. It was an 11-play drive that resulted in a 16-yard rush that ended in the end zone for Brandon Mackey, and then two plays into a drive, the fifth drive of the game for the Eagles, it was a 46-yard strike from Christian Miller to Dakari Ferguson, and that gives us the score, Jared, of 14-0.
Yeah, Judson definitely left some points out there, but defensively they've just been so dominant they've been able to get away with that. Christian Miller has been a little bit off with the deep ball, but he's been really accurate with the short passes, and I wouldn't be surprised if they try to just get him some simple throws, maybe some RPOs, some quick screens, just to get his confidence going and be able to move the ball to begin the third quarter.
Brandon Mackey, Ryan Otey, deep here for the Eagles as William Stoyanovich is ready to get us going here in the second half.
Haven't seen a whole lot from either special teams unit, especially in the return game. I wouldn't expect that to change here either.
Kick goes deep, fielded by, that looks like Sayers to me. Yeah, that is number three. Sayers is spinning and trying to pick up some more yardage on the return. Ends around the 30-yard line.
Yeah, good job by Sayers. Just, not trying to play hero there. If it's not there, let him get tackled and give your offense the ball. Obviously, a man down is going to.
We have the trainer on the sideline. Timeout for an injury. Timeout.
Third quarter offensively from scrimmage, but it's been a busy day for the injury bug for both teams. You hate to see this.
Well, and even for the officials as well, and it looked like good news as we left the booth here in between halves. The official that went down during the middle of the game seemed to be all right, was being tended to, and then the only other injury bug we saw was a big hit to Arthur Brantley, but he's back in the game. So I think all parties right now are good. We're just are looking at the injury happening on the far side of the field now at the 30-yard line. It looks like Franklin Sayers, who is an integral part of the secondary for this Judson team.
Yeah, he does a little bit of everything. He'll punt the ball, he'll return, he will play safety. He's a terrific player, a lot of fun to watch. You hate to see him go down.
Most definitely. He was an all-conference player in 2021. He is up, and he's going to walk off under his own power, so that is promising. But talk about the big week he had last week. 10 solo tackles, 22 tackles in total, 1.5 for loss, an interception, a forced fumble, and 3 pass breakups. This is a guy that
has been around, obviously, for the entirety of the program. This is only their second season. You can only hope he'll be able to return.
Well, as he's coming to the sideline, Sayers is kind of laughing and seems to be all right. We'll see if he re-enters the game when we see the Judson defense in this second half. But for now, it's the offense on the field. Christian Miller, 152 yards in the air and a touchdown. Here's an option play that he decides to keep, and he'll be met with a gain of maybe 3.
Yeah, and he made a good decision there of holding on to that ball, because if he pitched it when he wanted to, very well could have been.
Play the options, really, right? You really have to grind it out to find those big time plays. Options can go their way so quick.
Absolutely. Miller's done a good job of that.
Becomes 15th first.
Yeah, they've done a good job. A little bit off with the deep ball, but he's been really efficient with the short to intermediate throws today.
And hands off to Mackey. Mackey in the middle of a pile being pushed forward, fighting for extra yards, and that might go for a first down.
Wow, we haven't really touched on the offensive line, which is a shame because they've been great. But the left side and Derek DeVries. Silverstrand, great push up.
Those are the holdovers from last year's offensive line. It is a first down, but there is an Eagle down on the field.
Not sure who exactly it is, but we will have to wait and see. And it is the center, Antonio Rios. So now, perfect.
Interesting. Maybe cramps or something? Yeah, it's holding his. So as we come back, we watch Antonio Rios being helped off the field. So sliding into his position behind is Jacob Cooper. One freshman to another. Jacob Cooper, a freshman from South Elgin, Illinois. Keep you updated on Antonio Rios as we get that information. For now, though, it's a first and 10 from the 46-yard line of Madonna. Snap goes to Miller. Handoff goes to Mackey. Mackey's looking for the edge. He'll go out of bounds after a gain of maybe two. Clock keeps rolling, but there is a flag in the backfield, Jared.
Good job by Corcoran getting Mackey out of bounds to the sideline. You've had a lot of success running the ball. It might be time now to call a shot with the play action.
Sounds like a hold there against Jacob Cooper, the newly entered center. Just took over for Antonio Rios, so maybe a little bit of jitters there. Hope to calm that down for him, and instead it'll be a first down and 20.
I wouldn't be surprised here if Miller takes a shot with Vickers at the bottom of your screen.
It would be a good time for one, Jared. Man in motion is Stevens. He comes across the formation, drops back. Miller keeps his eyes deep, moves up through, gives way to Mackey, and Mackey slips one tackle, tries to break another. He'll go down for a gain of maybe six or seven at the 50-yard line.
Definitely not the best throw by Miller, but maybe the best read. Went through his progressions, checked the flat, looked over the top to Vickers. What does he do? He goes to his check down and his running back, Mackey, and allows him to get a good pickup on first down. And now back to about the original line of scrimmage. Not quite, but close.
Second down and 14. Looks to the flat for Vickers. Vickers with blockers in front. Gets to about the line to gain. Could be a first down here.
That was excellent blocking by Caleb Davis and Mahmoud Jihad. A little bit of a screen play, get them out, and a good downfield block, too, on the outside by Jordan West. Maybe the best blocking we've seen on a pass play today from these guys.
Well, the 6'3 Vickers, his knees must have hit before the top half of him because they're marking it short. It'll be third and two here. 12 minutes to play in the third. Miller takes a snap. Quick fire to the sideline. Caught and out of bounds. That's Ovante Vickers. Who else?
Yeah, right. If it ain't broke, why fix it?
And a first down.
He's been great all day today after the catch, creating separation. Vickers has been busy. He's essentially the safety blanket for Christian Miller, and he's now up to six catches.
You got a senior guy on your team like Vickers. You target him as much as you can. Handoff to Mackey off the left side. Little off-tackle run here. Mackey struggling for more. Breaks a tackle. Breaks another. And he's down at the 20 for a gain of about 13, maybe 14.
Yeah.
Jared, we've seen it all afternoon. He's a slippery back.
He sure is. Got a good initial push by the left tackle, Derek DeVries. Was a starter last season on the left side of the line, starting again today at left tackle. They have done a really good job running the football all day today.
Brandon Mackey on 15 attempts, now up over 100 yards on the ground. He's got 109 and a touchdown as first and 10 comes at the 20. Call it in the red zone. Judson has converted on one of these so far today. Handoff goes to Mackey. Mackey off the left side. He keeps churning for a first down. Put him up over 115 as another first down comes inside the 10-yard line. It'll be first and goal.
Carl Ware just over pursued on the edge, and Mackey only had one person to beat after that. It was the safety. He couldn't beat him, but either way, enough for a first down.
Now, do you in this situation here, first and goal, you've been moving it at will, and Mackey's been ripping off big chunks. Do you hand the ball off here, or do you try to get your All-American involved on the goal line?
Well, I think you run the ball, but I wouldn't be opposed to seeing Miller run with it. Maybe an option play.
Here's Miller. He goes to the flat for Mackey. Mackey looking for the pylon, and he's going to be brought down hard. That there is Carl Ware, a redshirt sophomore from Detroit. We've been calling his name a lot today, Jared.
Yeah, he missed the tackle on the previous play. He sure as heck didn't miss it there.
No, manhandling Mackey, sending him to the ground, making it second and goal from the six. Judson looking to go up by three scores here. You see Jordan West come onto the field. Jordan West had a great season last year as well. Impacted the game a lot from the slot in 21. Looks to have a similar role here in 22. Second and goal from the six. Just under 9.5 to play. Miller steps up through pressure and gets it to Vickers for the touchdown. He was sitting wide open. Touchdown Eagles.
They had two guys over there too, but both were playing behind him. An excellent job there by Vickers of just stopping and coming back to the football. Doesn't get much easier than that.
So on the opening drive of the second half, the Eagles march from their own 30 all the way down to the end zone, scoring their third touchdown of the day, the second through the air, first for Vickers, his second of the year. And they looked dominant yet again here as we open the second half. It'll be Colino for the extra point. And that's up and good. So a double-digit play drive takes about 6 minutes off the clock and results in a touchdown. 21-0 as we break. Thanks, Jared. Sometimes words are hard. The YouTube comments killing us?
I don't think so.
I always get nervous that they do it on YouTube because people can just say whatever they want. Unsportsmanlike conduct penalty was assessed to Judson, and so that will be enforced here on the kickoff.
Well, either way, you've got to be pleased if you're Judson. I don't think the unsportsmanlike conduct is ideal for Madonna, but as long as he doesn't do it again, he's okay. Great drive there, balance, running and passing, strong offensive line play. This is what you want to see if you're head coach Dan Poplazek. And now the question is, can you finish strong here? Because you want to, you haven't been in a position to win many games. You're 0-2. You don't want to see your team take their foot off the gas. You really want to see them play a whole game.
Well, totally. And this is a great coaching moment, right? In game situations. How are you going to handle a 21-point lead? Are you going to fall asleep at the wheel? Or are you going to put your foot on the throat, right? Is the kickoff is taken here by number 84 for the Crusaders. That's Jacob Ireland, and he's tackled around the 45-yard line. It'll be a first down, and we will see the Crusaders offense for the first time here in the second half.
Yeah, it was a little hole there. He just couldn't turn it upfield to the right. The next question is, if you're Judson, you've done a good job running the ball, and you've got a pretty good comfortable lead. Do you want to try maybe sprinkling some in, or excuse me, if you're defensively, do you want to maybe sprinkle a couple things in there that you haven't tried before? We've seen for the most part three down linemen. Maybe go to a 4-3. Do you want to show some blitzes from the outside? I don't know. We'll see.
It is DePaulis now in at quarterback. Takes the low snap. Now has to roll out and fire towards the sideline. Just getting rid of it there as he had three Judson Eagles swarming him there. Second down and 10.
Yeah, really good job by E.J. Glover forcing pressure and making DePaulis get rid of that ball a little bit earlier than he wanted to. They've been great all day today. This defensive line has been impressive.
You're right, and it has been utter domination against an offensive line that's, you know, looked a little slow, looked one that isn't necessarily operating as one unit. And now it's second down and 10. DePaulis out of the gun. Drops back, throws it into the flat for Allgood, who's met after a gain of 2. Looks like Chance Krajean.
Yeah, he's going to get close to midfield, which is going to bring up third and manageable. I like the decision just to try and get a quick hitter, and that's what he did with his running back But you've really struggled today on third down. In fact, Madonna hasn't – no, they have picked up one. They're 1-for-6 on third down today.
Madonna will desperately be trying to avoid their third shutout of the year. As DePaulis drops back on third, he's going to go down.
They brought pressure, it looks like, up the gut, too. A little bit of an A-gap blitz.
Jontrell Mitchell gets home for his second.
And Mitchell, the guy to make the sack, and he's been a busy guy today. And, well, A-gap pressure is hard to pick up. You leave the center with the responsibility, and good job by Judson of taking advantage.
So it'll be the sixth punt of the day for Madonna. William Stoyanovich, who had a really great punt, his second one, put it inside the 5-yard line. Ote back there telling everybody to stay away as it rolls inside the 15 near the 10, and it'll be waved dead. Good Justin will take over in just a moment with 7:50 left, Jared.
Yeah, good decision there not to touch it. Your offense has moved the ball well. Your defense has been great. Don't try and do anything that could give Madonna a chance to get back in this game. Now the question is, can you sustain another drive? A 3-score lead is nice. A 4-score lead would really put this game out of reach.
And again, we mentioned it towards the end of the first half. Judson's had 50 hung on them twice already this year. They want to put up one of their own and make their offense kind of get right. We mentioned that in the open of this game. This is technically and is looking so far like a get-right game for Judson. And you know, this is a great opportunity for in-game reps for a lot of your guys that are going to battle for you all year long. Here is Christian Miller again. Looks like Nigel Bruce in the backfield, and he gets the handoff off the tackle. Following some blocks, gets another burst to the outside. A nice run there for Nigel Bruce, and a flag probably for a late hit.
A really good block on the outside by the tight end, Keontae Fox. You talk about stretching the play. He did that there, and I'm curious to see what this flag is. You might be right. A late hit against Madonna. It should be another 15 yards added to the play.
Jesse Morris, the guilty party. So tack on another 15 to the end of that run for Nigel Bruce. The gain itself was about 15, so 30 yards forward or so for Judson. Now from the 40-yard line, it'll be first and 10.
I think you got to start selling out a little bit if you're Madonna. Try to bring more than just 3 or 4 guys. Now they're starting to crowd that line of scrimmage.
Now a pass tipped in the air and intercepted. Intercepted by Cortland Cochran. Makes one cut, falls down inside the 15.
Yeah, it was deflected at the line of scrimmage, and you can thank Nigel Bruce because he just saved the touchdown there with that tackle.
Fourth interception of the year for Christian Miller, and one that probably shouldn't be marked on his ledger. One of those interceptions you wish there was a separate category for as a quarterback. Nonetheless, it's going the other way, and this is the best field position that Madonna has had all afternoon.
Yeah, and I'll tell you what, we talked about it. There's a big difference between a 3-score lead and a 4-score lead, and, well, now a 3-score lead could come with a 2-score lead because, like you said, best field position all day. You got to take advantage here if you're Madonna.
So with DePaulis under center, first and 10 from the 13-yard line. He drops, looks right, fires actually over the middle. This one goes to Luke Fromm. Fromm, a junior from Warren, Michigan. Played a little quarterback for this team last year, but now settles in a role as a second-string tight end for the Crusaders.
Yeah, good job there. Just a little hitch route over the middle, almost like a curl, if you will, and just take what you can get over the middle.
Tough to defend when you're running a zone defense, as it looked like the Eagles were doing there. 6:50 left, second down and 3. Shotgun formation, wide receivers to either side. And the handoff goes to Nicarius Allgood, battling for yards at the line. It looks to be short of the first down marker.
I'll tell you what, though, instead of being tackled in the backfield for a loss, he was able to weave through for a couple yards, and that's big right there, because all of a sudden it could be second and long. Instead, it's, you know, second and seven, second and eight.
On the carry there, I think it was all good. Tough to see with the yellow on white for Madonna, but we push forward with a third down and one with 6 minutes to play in the third. Fake handoff, goes to the end zone, incomplete.
Just way too much heat on that. He had it. The pressure definitely affected the throw.
DePaulis looking for Fromm on that
one. Yeah, DePaulis had his man, and it looks like they brought the safety in there to rush the passer. And it was a good job by David Dunbar.
And if you're a Madonna, down three scores with 6 minutes left in the third, you really have to go for this fourth and short in the red zone.
Yeah, there's no doubt about it. You have to go for this.
Madonna's going to call a timeout, and we'll take a quick break right along with them. 21-0 as we head to break. Oh, that's good news, but a little too late. Tony La Russa will not return as manager for the White Sox this year, as if it matters at this point.
For this season or next season?
This season, no. 2022. He shouldn't return ever, but... here for a fourth and short try for Madonna. This year on fourth down, Madonna 4 for 8, and in the red zone they are 5 for 10 with 3 touchdowns this year. Motion man goes to the right. Snap goes to DePaulis. DePaulis looking for the end zone. It's caught for a touchdown. Luke Fromm, junior from Warren, Michigan, hauls it in for the first score of the day for Madonna. There goes the shutout.
And I will tell you right now, DePaulis has a gun. This kid can rifle it over the middle. He really has some velocity. I wouldn't be surprised if he plays baseball here, but a good job by Fromm of just catching that thing.
With the score, it brings out William Stojanovic for an extra point. Well, we have not yet seen him fill today, but 2 for 3 last week against Northwoods. Yep. Kick is good. 21-7, we head to break. We'll see Christian Miller and company when we come back.
Now you got a ball game.
I got a ball game.
I think it's 80.
Okay.
Avant row.
21-7 as Stojanovic is ready to break open play yet again. Kicks it deep, fielded by an up man. That up man goes all the way to the 40-yard line.
Yeah, it had some good height on it, but it just did not carry all that far. And now we got a late skirmish, and this is actually getting a little bit... Somebody lost a helmet too. Well, the question is this on both teams? Is it going to be offsetting penalties? Is it on Judson? Because if it is, that negates good field position.
Two flags out on the play. It was Jalen Trice that was getting that earful coming back towards the sideline from Coach Poplazek. Maybe a late hit or something, but Trice was the one that kind of got pulled out of that pile by a teammate. I don't know if we ever figured out who had the return there, but the referees talk it over. Here's Heath Powell. I think we're going to get an unsportsmanlike penalty. Oh.
Yeah, that's a big loss.
And let's admonish Jalen Trice from the record. That's Jared Brooks that was getting the earful coming back towards the sideline. And we won't be talking about Brooks anymore this afternoon. He has been disqualified from participation this afternoon.
Yeah, and it's unfortunate, too, because it takes away great field position. You were going to go to work from your own 40, and now you're going to work from your own 25. So it's just like a touchback on a kick that didn't even make it to the 25. Just not a smart play there.
Right, and on it, and that's one of those mistakes that, you know, year three, year four, you'd hope by year two you have it worked out, but certainly, you know, as we get further into this year, that's something that company are going to have to coach out of this team.
Yeah, you'd like to think you could clean that up earlier, but that didn't happen.
So here's Miller from the 15. But not before a whistle and a false start.
I'll tell you what, this second half looked to be going Judson's way, and all of a sudden, following that interception and then touchdown, it has been all Madonna. This game is far from over with 5 minutes and 30 seconds in the third. You really got to regroup right now.
And now they're backed up even further. First and 15 from the 10. Did see them drive 99 yards earlier that resulted in a touchdown. Pass over the middle to Vickers is incomplete. And there's a flag in the backfield.
I don't think Miller got hit late, but it's thrown in the backfield right around the quarterback. So we'll see what this is ruled.
Waiting to hear from the head official. Wow. So that sets you back even further now, as it was first and 15 from the 10. It'll now be a half the distance to the goal penalty, and so we'll see this ball be placed about the 5-yard line, and it'll be first and 20.
I don't know what you draw up here on first and 20. Near your own goal line, you might just want to be conservative and run the ball.
Miller takes a snap and looks left, and he gets out of pressure. Would have been a safety, fires it out of bounds, and now Madonna's looking for an intentional grounding penalty.
But he looked
to be out of the back of the pocket there.
I'm not convinced he did get out of the pocket.
I'm not either, and they're talking about it.
I'm shocked this is not intentional grounding.
Oh, and they're going to call it. You see the body language by Miller.
Man, it's the right call, too. Man, it will be a safety, and that'll be 9 unanswered points now for the Madonna Crusaders. They have turned this thing around.
Well, it's kind of an odd score to reach how the way they did it, 7-2 to get their average points per game of 9, but they've reached 9, and they're making this a ball game, Jared.
This game is far from over.
And it's not really anything that they're doing on defense right now. It's really the fact that Judson's kind of imploding on themselves offensively. A tip pass turns into a long interception return, and you back yourself so far up right there that it turns into a safety.
Yeah, and I don't think they had the communication they wanted to on the play, because Miller turned as if he was going to hand that ball off, and there was no one to give it to. He made the right decision throwing it away, but you just would hope he would have been able to find someone to throw it to over the middle of the field. That's a huge penalty, and you're going to get a chance to get really good at field position because you're going to be punting now from your own 20.
Yeah, with the free kick here, and now this drive becomes paramount for the comeback here for the Crusaders. If you can go 9 unanswered and stretch that somewhere close to 16 unanswered, maybe 17 unanswered, then you've really made this a ball game. You'd have to assume maybe they do go for 2 if they get a touchdown here, but that's a later conversation for a different situation. Right now, we're focused on a free kick coming from Thomas Colino. I'm willing to say this is probably his first ever free kick.
Man, very well could be.
Sends it away. Gets some good height on it. Fielded there by Chestnut. Chestnut makes a move and gets up to the 50-yard line. So it is great field position for Madonna's offense as they come back out onto the field with an opportunity to make this even closer. We take a quick break. 21-9, 5:13 to play in the third as we go to break. Called for a fair catch there. 21-3 as the Crusaders come back out onto the field. Josh DePaulis still in at quarterback. Arthur Brantley likely done for the day. DePaulis drops back, looks down the field, fires over the middle. He's got Chestnut, but he can't reel it in.
Yeah, it looks like they found a soft spot in the coverage on the post route. And it was a good throw from DePaulis. He got to make that catch, and it just was not executed. And all the momentum has gone now in Madonna's favor.
And if they had they made that play, you really feel like it's completely on their side. But a chance at life now if Judson can make a big play here on second and 10. Of course, no more Jared Brooks. He's been disqualified. Jacob Slonsky slots in at that position. And a timeout for Judson called by Dan Poplazek.
I'm really surprised by that timeout. Unless you were completely out of sync, I don't know why you would take it. Maybe just try to regroup your team because it has gone south pretty fast.
I think he probably feels that way. He probably there was probably some miscommunication there on the coverage or the alignment of the defense there, and he sees that and says, we are completely out of sorts at the moment. That was an awful drive for the offense, and now we're coming out here. We almost get gashed with a deep ball by a team that has 64 yards coming out of half. This is probably a get-right timeout.
Yeah, I'm not so sure you're going to see the most pleasant Poplazek either here. You can't see inside the huddle, but I imagine he's pretty fired up.
With every right to be so, and so they break the huddle after the timeout. 5:07 on the clock. Again, Judson leads 21-9. 9 unanswered points, as Jared mentioned moments ago, by Madonna. So now 2nd and 10, 3 receivers to the bottom of the formation. DePaulis fires toward the near side, caught.
Did he stay in bounds? I think he did. He got a foot down. Another good pass rush, but nice job by DePaulis getting rid of it and going to his go-to guy,
Devonta Garrett.
And Devonta Garrett. Now, that's not what you want to see out of a timeout, that's for sure.
Yeah, Garrett's the number one here, that's for sure. 12 catches and 161 yards coming into today, and 2 touchdowns as well, both of those TDs coming last week against Northwoods. Now a run up the middle. This one goes for decent yardage. I think the ball carrier was kind of carried over a would-be tackler.
And Josh Mason is slow to get up. He's had a really good game, especially early on. And I like the decision to run the ball after the passing play that picked up the first down. You don't have to be in panic mode. There's still a lot of time, and you are within 2 scores.
Second down and short here for the Crusaders. Chestnut, the lone receiver to the bottom of the formation. DePaulis takes the snap, now hands to Spencer Rivera. Rivera tackled almost immediately.
Very nice tackle at the line of scrimmage by Bryce Heary. Now the question is, as you continue to move the ball, you started to see the corners come up and play press coverage. Do you want to take a shot? Because I didn't see a safety towards the sideline. I saw it almost in the middle of the field. You might have a chance down the sideline on a fade ball or even maybe a post or a corner.
You can sense the enthusiasm and by Madonna's offense here as they come out and basically drag Spencer Rivera off the field, who was down with an injury. They want to keep this momentum rolling on their side and not give Judson a chance to breathe here, Jerry.
You're absolutely right, and this is not what you wanted to see. You come out the second half opening series, you get a touchdown, then you throw the pick. That leads to a touchdown. You get a great return that's negated by an unsportsmanlike penalty. As a result, one of your players is disqualified. And then you get a safety, and now Madonna's moving the ball here, looking like they might put up some more points.
Here's the press coverage you just mentioned a few moments ago, as DePaulis keeps on the option. He's going to try to fall forward for a first down on third down, and it's very close.
I'll tell you what, that was read perfectly by the defense. A good job keeping containment on the outside.
And they're going to call it a first down.
Wow, I thought he was a little bit short, but a generous spot's going to move the sticks.
So now a first down and 10 from the 23-yard line.
21-9 with 3 minutes to go. You've got to find a way to get a stop if you're Madonna or if you're Judson.
DePaulis over the middle. Caught and bobbled. That one's hit out of the hands of maybe Emerson Combs, who came across the middle there.
I'll tell you what, DePaulis, I think, when he looks back at this game, will realize he's putting too much mustard on these throws. A little bit of touch there and probably a completion.
Yeah, went in and out of the hands of the intended receiver, and then the hit laid by E.J. Glover was enough to make that an incompletion, so now second and 10. Tight end in motion, Connor Kerrigan. Immediate pressure in the face of DePaulis, and he throws a near interception. Brandon Brown was almost there, it looked like.
Yeah, he had to get rid of it. Good job by Jontrell Mitchell getting to the quarterback. DePaulis has no time there and just made the right decision throwing it away.
Not Brandon Brown. That was actually Dehavion Allen. Dehavion Allen. And safety there.
You might need to do some rollouts. You're having a really hard time stopping the pass rush from the middle, and you can see right now they've got five lined up around the line of scrimmage. I would expect some pressure here.
So now the drive with so much momentum is at a third and 10, and a miscommunication. This one's going to go incomplete. The intended receiver was Chestnut, who ran a curl route instead of the go route to the end zone, and so it'll be fourth and 10.
Now, is that intentional grounding? I don't know. There was no one in the vicinity. He was in the pocket.
I think you likely see the intention there on a three-step drop and say that probably wasn't intentional grounding. It would just be my reasoning if I'm a referee.
Yeah, I think you have to go for it here.
You must. Yeah, this is an opportunity to swing momentum in your favor for the Crusaders. Crowd at full throat. Fourth and 10 for Madonna. DePaulis drops, fires toward the end zone. It's incomplete. Again, Chestnut pulling up short.
Excellent job on the outside there by cornerback DeVavion Allen. DeVavion has had a busy day, and there maybe the biggest play of the game for Judson, just to give you some momentum.
So a turnover on downs, and now this turns into a very crucial drive for the Eagles. You got to get right here. You got to try to get this game back under control. A little bit of craziness here in the latter stages of the third quarter. Still 21-9, you still lead by two scores, but now you have to come out and put together a really cohesive drive.
Yeah, you want a long drive more than anything. You don't even need it to end in points. You just want a lot of time to come off the clock.
A rollout here as the pass was intended for Vickers, knocked down at the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, good job getting his hands up there by Will Fenema the second, because Vickers was open, and that was the difference between a completion and incompletion, was that deflection.
So it'll be second and 10. Judson getting in to the line with some pace. Two receivers low, one man high. As Miller takes the snap, turns and hands to Mackey. Mackey with a hole with some room. Mackey had one man to beat, and he brings him down. No.
Yeah, he did. Did the ball come out? I thought maybe it did. I don't know for certain, but either way, a good job there by Mackey with the huge run off tackle.
And it's been a lot between the guards in the first quarter. Now we've seen a lot of off-tackle runs by both Mackey and Nigel Bruce here in the second half as Mackey rips off another big run, going for about 14 yards on first down.
And
a flag.
I think we're going to get a push in the back on Judson. I thought the blocker was playing till the whistle. I did not think that was against Judson. I didn't think it was late. Let's see. Okay, so it was a sideline warning. That would have negated a huge run. They are getting a nice push on this series.
So it'll be first down and 10 once more. The ball placed. We just drop?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I'll tell him. Feet died.
Hey. Back to the time for third down and 13. The second down play was a big loss on the ground for Mackey. And now the third and long. This is likely a passing situation here, Jared, with 50 seconds on the clock.
I wouldn't completely say that just because you're probably going to go for it on fourth down. But what do you know? You're right.
Miller gets his pass batted up in the air. It was intended for Vickers. It falls incomplete. It will be fourth down. I think Miller's looking for a flag on the action that happened around the 30-yard line.
I'll tell you what, though. They have done an excellent job in the second half. Madonna at the line of scrimmage of getting their hands up, and that was all created by Jabari Gaines.
So a man down at the 30. It'll be fourth and 13 when we come back. Judson leads 21-9, 37 seconds left, and we take a break. Back here with 37 seconds left in the third quarter. Streamwood High School hosts the Eagles and Crusaders. The Eagles lead 21-9. And Jared, if you were looking right there in that huddle here towards this sideline, Coach Poplazek in the middle of it being absolutely animated with his offense.
Yeah, a great opening series to begin the third, but since then have really slowed down, and now this drive much, much better.
Fourth and 13. And the punt is a good one. Fair caught. This one's going to land inside the five, roll into the end zone for a touchback.
Just a good job of getting the punt off. Last thing you need is a block. And, if worse comes to worse, it goes into the own end zone, so be it.
Well, and that was a really productive drive. Again, one that started at their own 15-yard line, and then you get all the way down to the 25 or so. And things get absolutely turned around. It looked like Madonna was willing to sell out on the run during the time that we were off the air for that brief moment. But now Donna gets it, ball on the 20. And again, momentum still technically in their favor, but like you said before that last Judson drive, you're just kind of looking for a long, sustainable drive. They got that, But now the defense needs to show up, too.
And Judson has done a good job today defensively. I know they gave up the touchdown, but the safety isn't on them. Madonna has really struggled to put together consistency on offense. I'd like to see the defensive line get after it here.
Fire over the middle, and it's dropped, a near interception. That looks like Slonsky. No. Jontrell Mitchell.
Yeah, and that's a catch you got to make. I know it's not easy. A ball comes in a little hot, but you do a great job reading it. You undercut it. You got to make the play there.
And while DePaul, as we've noted, has a rocket arm, he's been making some throws that are somewhat questionable. The good ones have been dropped, and there's others that, like that one, are near interceptions. It's probably the second one like that we've seen today.
Yeah, and up 21-9. That would have been a big play because it would have given your offense great field position.
Fires across the middle. This one thrown behind Devonta Garrett. It'll be 3rd and 10.
Yeah, and you can see some frustration there from Novell Chestnut. He was open, and he is letting DePaulis know he was open.
So now 3rd and 10, 20 seconds left in the third. And the blue crew here in the stands for Judson getting going. You can hear him banging on the drums, or the buckets, so to speak. The blue crew with the bucket boys. 3rd and 10. Drops back, looks our way, fires our way. That's Connor Kerrigan. Makes the catch.
Yeah, good job there hauling it in by Kerrigan. A two-score game. I don't see why you would punt this ball or why you would go for it here, but definitely probably let the end of the quarter hit.
Yeah, and it will wind down. Hold your fours up, Judson faithful. We go to the fourth quarter, up 21-9 as we go to break, back with the last quarter of this homecoming game from Millennium Stadium in Streamwood, Illinois, after this.
So the scoreboard is not... The scoreboard isn't working, so you should probably do the score probably every 60 seconds.
Okay. Back for fourth down to start the fourth quarter. Crusaders have elected to punt it. Stojanovic sends it deep, a nice spiraling kick that lands near the 30. Fielded by Ote, he's going to be met there and dropped.
By far and away the best punt today from either punter, and just a good job by Ote of catching the football, because the last thing you want to do is give Madonna good field position. The emphasis here in the fourth quarter has got to be ball control.
Ball control and good clock management. If you look, the first quarter or the first half of this game, Madonna possessed the ball 7 minutes and 34 seconds. Judson over 22 and a half minutes. And now that has since leveled a bit, 13 minutes of possession for Madonna after that last drive, after the third quarter is updated. We've got about 13 minutes of action for Madonna. So they put together what they had in one half and one quarter in terms of time of possession. Quick pass out to Ferguson here on the flat, trying to break a tackle. He's thrown out of bounds, and a flag, likely for a face mask there.
Yeah, I think you're right. It looked like Julius Adams at the very last second got his finger in between one of the holes of the face mask. That's really unfortunate, too, if you're Madonna. Huge break for Judson because you sniffed it out perfectly on 1st and 10.
So add an additional 15 yards to the end of that play, which went for about a yard.
It'll be a new set of downs, too.
Yep.
And the penalties racking up for both teams.
After a pretty clean first half.
Yeah, you got that right. Judson, 80 yards in penalties. And Madonna now with almost 50.
Five penalties for Madonna, eight for the Eagles. First down and 10 from the 46. And the handoff goes to Nigel Bruce off tackle, looking for the edge. Finds it just a bit, breaks a tackle. Now spins out of another before he is pushed out of bounds. A gain of nearly 20.
Yeah, I think it's coming back, though. It was the first time today we've seen the jet sweep. The receiver get it on the motion. Unfortunately, it's coming back.
Two steps forward, one step back, or maybe one step forward, two step back. You get the face mask penalty, and then you get brought back with a hold. So essentially, it's a net gain of five on the drive so far.
Yep, yep. Not what you want there if you're head coach Poplazic.
And now it's almost a full football field of penalties, pretty much just in the second half for Judson as they go now first down and 15. Bruce in motion. Handoff goes to Mackey. We saw this a lot in the first quarter and in the first half as Mackey stumbles forward for a gain of nearly 10.
I'll tell you what, at the end of the day, if you're going to give a game ball, consider Derek DeVries. Man, did he do a great job at the end coming in and pushing forward at the pile to give a couple extra yards for Brandon Mackey.
That's one of the team leaders for sure. Your left tackle has got to be somebody who sets the tone offensively. Brandon Mackey on 19 carries, now up over 165 yards. He's got a touchdown as well and a long today of 33, averaging 8.5 yards per touch. Bruce in motion again. Fake handoff to Mackey. Miller rolls out. Got pressure in his face, fires, and that one is
intercepted. The question is, did he get a foot down?
And that's what we're waiting for.
I think he did.
I think they're going to call it an interception, but still an official ruling is what we're waiting for.
This is a huge call.
A meeting between the referees on the far side.
And they
and
are.
It's Madonna's football.
Wow.
An interception there on a play that likely you should probably just throw that ball out of bounds with so many people on one side of the field.
Yeah, I'll tell you what, I didn't even see who got the interception. Maybe we'll see it here on the replay. But either way, that's you can't do that. The turnovers right now are what will kill you if you're Judson. You cannot afford to give life to a team like this. And Madonna, who has really struggled to move the ball.
So it's the second interception of the day for Christian Miller. After a really clean first half, Judson's offense is sputtering just a bit here as we head down the stretch. 13-15 left in the game. Judson still leads 21-9. Back on the field, the Crusader offense, as DePaulis takes a low snap, fires it over the middle, and knocked down by, it looked like, E.J. Glover.
Yeah, nice job there. Again, both defensive lines have done an excellent job of getting their hands up and just getting in the way enough, even if you're not deflecting it, to alter the throw. It was a good job.
DePaulis, a 6-foot quarterback weighing about 190 pounds. The middle part of his line, guard, center guard, 6'1", 6'4", 6'3". So kind of a difficult situation to get that ball over them and then also get that over the linebackers as well. It's now 2nd and 10, but we get a flag.
Yeah, it looks like this is going to be an early movement against the Madonna Crusaders. You've really struggled offensively. I know we sound like a broken record, but to only be down 21-9 in the fourth quarter, you've got to be pleased with that if you're Herb Haygood. The question is, can you get the big play? You have shown through three quarters that you cannot consistently move the ball. You need a chunk play.
Yeah, well, they had an opportunity to chunk play earlier in the game, but dropped by Chestnut. And so you wonder if Haygood and his play caller are maybe now a little gun-shy at shooting it down the field. DePaulis drops, fires over the middle, caught there maybe by Garrett, and he picks up a gain of maybe 10.
That wasn't the smartest decision by Garrett. After the catch, he went backwards for a little bit, and I know he was just seeing if he wanted to see if he could make a couple of guys miss, but you got to go forward, get the extra yards to set up third and short instead of third and four.
Still, it makes it more manageable either way. You just like to have that extra yard.
The question is this four-down territory? You are with 12 minutes late in the 12 minutes in the fourth. I don't think it is necessarily.
Third down and four. Fires over the middle. This one is.
He catch it?
Caught.
Wow. That was pretty good coverage there by DeVavion Allen. But give credit to Garrett hauling it in.
Yeah, great catch there by Devonta Garrett, the number one here with Madonna, who now on the day has two receptions. And it's a fresh set of downs for Madonna. Snap. DePaulis. Sacked. Big time stop there by the Judson defense.
And that defensive line has been busy all day. Good decision there by DePaulis just to take the sack, but a huge play by Bryce Heary. We've called his name a couple times so far here in the second half.
The freshman from Janesville, Wisconsin, making an impact today. I believe that to be his second sack of the day, if I have my numbers right.
I think you're right.
Third tackle for loss. So now DePaulis drops back, evades a little pressure, looking down the field, fires it low to Chestnut. Will there be a flag? No flag. It's incomplete, and it'll move to third down.
Yeah, Matrez Rawls looked like he may have gotten there a little tad earlier, the little wraparound, but no flag and a big stop by the Judson defense.
So now third and extremely long for Madonna as they're near midfield.
Yeah, I think you got to punt this ball. You still have enough time down two scores, and Judson's offense is just, they've been a little bleak here in the second half.
Certainly need a big play here, and that helps you decide, too. If it's third and one, or fourth and one, rather, then you're maybe thinking about going for it. But from here, maybe not. DePaulis drops back, fires over the middle. It is caught. That's reeled in by number 80.
Short of the marker, though, right?
The gentleman they call Haram Carreras. Short of the marker. It's fourth down and seven, and they're leaving the offense out there.
We had the down wrong. I thought that was fourth down.
The last play with third and extremely long, now fourth down, and they'll leave the offense out there for, well, they're needing about 7 yards here.
Yeah, I think you the decision now where you're at is the right one to go for it.
DePaulis drops back. Steps through a little pressure, fires toward the sideline, and the carry is all good. Lets it go off of the shoulder pads, and it falls incomplete. Would have been a first down.
What a great job by DePaulis, evading pressure, stepping up, and then throwing
a
dart. No, it's on the offense. Yeah. Illegal motion or ineligible man downfield.
Got to tell you, I didn't see the laundry go up in the air, so I was excited for a second.
Yeah, a lot of flag.
Turnover on downs gives the ball near midfield in their own territory, but certainly in favorable field position. And Madonna's defense has to come up with a huge stop now because it's getting to crunch time. 10.5 minutes left. You're still down by two scores.
Yeah, 21-9, and it doesn't feel like it, though. If you were just tuning in, or you've only been watching the second half, it's been mostly Madonna with the momentum.
Likely to see a lot of run here. Brandon Mackey looking for a 200 yards day, about 23 yards short of that at the moment.
Yeah, I would feed him the football here. You know how Zeke Elliott wrote on his stomach or tattooed on his stomach?
Feed me.
Yeah, that should be the case here.
Fake handoff to Ferguson. Mackey gets the carry, tackled at the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, good stop up front by Madonna. They've really had a salt for the run here. And Nick Miller, first time we've seen him get involved on the run there.
Nick Miller, shout out to all the New Girl fans out there. He's a big Chicago Bear fan, Nick Miller.
Oh, interesting.
So now second down and 10. Two receivers high, Siebens alone at the bottom of the formation. Under 10 minutes to play in this game. Ferguson in motion, fakes the handoff. It goes to Mackey. Mackey breaks the tackle and will get maybe a yard.
Yeah, and the man that had a chance to bring him down for a loss was Cole Staten. He just couldn't make the play, but This is a good job defensively late in the game by Madonna. And I think if you're Judson, you're making the right decision. You haven't been able to do much offensively through the air in the second half. So keep it on the ground and try to take as much time off the clock as
at
you can.
At what point do you think the handoff goes to the man in motion on one of these run plays?
Well, we saw it on the previous series, but it got called back on a block in the back. I think if you see it on the read play, you give it to him.
Third and eight. High snap. Handoff goes to Mackey. Mackey battles forward. It's a first down.
Yeah, good job there by Christian Miller just handling that high snap. It came in a little hot. And that's huge because now you can probably take off another 2 minutes.
9 minutes to play exactly. 21-9 is our score. Second meeting between these two schools. Judson won last year 41-14 out in Livonia, Michigan. We called a lot of firsts for this team last year, Jared, and they're looking for their first homecoming win in program history. First down and 10 from the 49-yard line of Madonna. Miller takes a snap, fakes a handoff, screen pass out to Dakari Ferguson, who's looking to break one tackle and is dragged down by the jersey near the 45-yard line. Clock keeps rolling.
Good job by Ferguson of staying in bounds. I know he probably wanted to get the extra couple of yards, but right now in this situation, up two scores, stay in bounds and let that clock roll.
And that's an important thing to pay attention to here as well for Poplasek's team is who knows their who has a high football IQ, who knows to stay in bounds and exactly how to run more time off the clock and keep it out of the hands of the Crusaders offense. Something to watch as we progress. Second down and six. Miller with Mackey behind him. Three receivers to the top of the formation against Stevens alone down here at the bottom. Miller takes a high snap, corrals it, gives to Mackey. Mackey looking to go off tackle, makes one move and is tackled at the line of scrimmage. Getting in there looked like Paul McLeod, a sophomore safety from Sarasota, Florida.
Now you got to ask yourself if you're Herb Haygood, do you consider using a timeout if you get the stop here on third down? Down 21-9 with 7 minutes to go, maybe not, but I think the thought trickles in the back of your head.
It certainly does, and we'll see how much time they're willing to secede here. If you're the Crusaders offense, if you're Josh DePaulis sitting on the other sideline, you really have to be thinking, okay, it's time to uncork some long balls here and be a little bit more accurate. But for right now, we're focused on this third down and six. Man in motion, Jordan West, fakes the handoff. It goes to Mackey, looking to get off tackle, and he's tackled down in the backfield by Carl Ware, and we've called his name a ton today.
Yeah, Carl Ware with maybe the biggest tackle of the season, because if Ware doesn't make that tackle, Mackey probably has the first down. And now, Judson, I think you're okay with that. You ran some time off the clock. You're up 21-9. The worst comes to worst, you give up a punt, and you trust your defense to make some plays.
So on fourth down and nine, the punt will come from Colino. This is a nice spiraling kick that's going to be called off by Ireland, and he muffs it! It's on the ground, and Judson falls on it!
That is why you like a punter who can get a lot of height on the ball, because it makes it harder to catch. And that's what you saw happen.
A huge swing in this game, and that will bode incredibly well for Judson's chances of pulling out of this game with a victory. Now set up inside the 15-yard line and a chance to drive a dagger, Jared.
Yeah, that is a dagger. I don't know if it is the dagger, but that is huge. You get a stop for the Madonna defense and special teams, and you just muff the punt.
So coming back out now is Christian Miller. Again, a chance to drive a dagger here and fade to black. If you can put another score on the board, just under 6 minutes to play. Still just a two-score game. 21-9 is our score.
I'm getting a little wildcat here.
I was about to say, I don't see Miller in almost a high snap. Miller does get it anyway, even though he had what looked to be a fullback in front of him. And he marches forward for maybe a gain of one.
Well, I think with the way things have gone offensively in the second half, you might as well try it. And I think you got to run the ball here, take the time off. And I don't know if you start using your timeouts yet, but definitely, again, the thought's got to be there because you're down two scores.
Now, Jared, I don't know if you've noticed this trend or not, but there's been a lot of high snaps here lately to Miller, and you have to be very cautious of that if you're Judson. You can't squander this opportunity.
Yeah, no, you got to get the snap right.
Second down and appears to be nine.
I didn't see anybody jump.
So that'll set Judson back again, and again, a very sloppy second half.
Yeah, but hey. If you can hold it out, a win's a win.
Sloppy wins are wins. They have looked very competent on the offensive side of things. Christian Miller having a good day. Two interceptions, but really only one of them should be on his ledger. Currently just under 200 yards passing, two touchdowns, and the run game today has just been incredible. 25 carries for Brandon Mackey. He's at 187 yards and a touchdown. Nigel Bruce, the number two here, has got four carries for 46 as we are under 5:20 to play, and Miller's having a hard time getting the call from the sideline. Now he sets himself up. Adana packing the box. They're selling out for run here, it looks like. Still they can't get the play call in. And a timeout will be called.
Yeah, I like the decision. Just call a timeout. Not the last thing you need is a little miscommunication and some points going the other way. I guess we'll keep it here, but if you're Judson, I think you got to keep the ball on the ground.
Yeah, that's the only way to go here. You sell out for the run. Even if it goes nowhere, you got to take time off the clock. You've tried some screen passes. Those have been sniffed out pretty well here by the Crusader defense. I don't think you take a shot at the end zone here. You have the lead. You just have to manage the clock.
Yeah, I agree with you. And, again, with 4:59 to go, maybe you're in the situation now if you are Madonna head coach Herb Haygood. Do you use your timeout, assuming that Judson keeps the ball on the ground, or do you let that clock roll and save those timeouts for the potential after fact of a scoring drive?
We'll see how it shakes out down the stretch here. Under five to play. It's a second down and long for the Eagles. One man in the backfield, that's Mackey. Receivers to either side, double tight end set. Man in motion is Siebens. Handoff goes to Mackey. Mackey to the left side, off tackle, and he'll be brought down after a short gain.
Good tackle there by Madonna. Good job selling out. And now you are in crunch time. You have to get these stops if you're going to have any chance of coming back. If you're Judson, a first down probably seals it.
So a third down inside the 10, and I agree with you. First down probably does seal this game for the Eagles. So this is a gigantic play here for Judson's offense. Miller hands off to Mackey. Mackey up the middle is met and stopped short of the line to gain. It'll be about a fourth and four, field goal or go for it.
I would go for it, but.
You're a madman.
Why? A field goal still keeps it a two-score game.
That's true.
I would go for it.
But keeps it even closer.
Yeah, but look where they are, and they haven't moved the ball all that well. I would go for it. They're at, the Madonna 8? I would go for this.
Well, they're going to send Colino onto the field for 3 points here. Colino this year, field goal opportunities, 2 for 3 and a long of 34. This one being lined up from about 25 yards out. Low snap, corralled, kick is up, kick is good for Colino, and it's a 15-point game.
Yeah, it's nice to get it up to 15 because now you know if you give up a touchdown, the fact that they would have to score again plus the two-point conversion.
Right. It's going to take a lot for Madonna to get even in this game, especially with only 3.5 left. But we take a break. Judson leads 24-12. Or no, to 9. They put 12 on the board. 24-9, we promise. Be back after this.
North Central.
After his successful field goal attempt, Colino now on for the kickoff. 24-9 with 3:29 left in the game. The Crusaders technically not done, but definitely have a steep hill to climb. The kick goes deep and over towards Ireland, who now gives off to Deshaun Hayes, who's going the other way.
I love it.
Yeah, you
need some creativity. Down 15 with 3:23. Why not try and end around on the return? And now you definitely have to go to the air consistently. Not that they haven't done that already.
So the drive will start from the Crusaders' own 28-yard line. They got about eight more yards than they would have on a touchback. So they got to go to work, and you're 100% right. I think it's even the novice football fans' idea is, oh, we got to throw the ball here. They got to go down the field and look for a guy like Devonta Garrett, Novell Chestnut, guys that have been held in check for the most part today. Outside of a long of 38 through the air, Chestnut really hasn't been a factor. DePaulis fires over the middle. It's picked! Picked off Jontrell Mitchell, and he goes down inside the 25. That's a fade to black moment right there.
I thought I saw a flag for the moment, but no, Jontrell Mitchell. He dropped the pick earlier. That's going to seal this one.
With 3 minutes left, all you do is run the clock down, and that will about do it.
I'll tell you what, those sixes and eights look a lot alike.
Yeah, I've thought the zeros and eights look a lot alike, too.
Yeah.
But still, an interception by Jontrell Mitchell, his first of the year. And DePaulis throws his fourth interception of the year.
Yeah, he had to. And a really good job of anticipating that pass over the middle of the field. Almost deked him into it.
So Miller has Mackey behind him. Mackey 6 yards shy of 200 yards on the ground. He'll turn and hand to him. No, this is Sherron Boyd. Excuse me. Boyd finds the edge, and Boyd battles inside the 10-yard line for a fresh set of downs.
Yeah, and you just want to stay in bounds now. That's all you want to do.
It'll be first and 10 from about the 7-yard line. Brandon Mackey will break a record that he set last year for rushing yards in a game. Had 115 in 2021, but as we mentioned now, is at 194. That's a pretty hefty number there, Jared.
You're not joking. Very impressive running attack today all the way around by this Judson football team.
I think if you're the Crusaders, too, you're looking for a big stand here. You don't want your team to roll over and die if you're D.C., Kevin O'Donnell, or head coach Herb Haygood. You want this to be a good drive as Sherron Boyd is met in the backfield and will be brought down. A couple of flags on the play, though.
Yeah, I think there might be a face mask there. Both teams late. Johnston.
game as the Eagles look to try to close out the Crusaders. Dance party in Streamwood as the Judson faithful are excited about what likely will be a victory on homecoming day. Stands have been packed all afternoon for this game, Jared. Good to see the Judson faithful back after a year off from football. Well, a calendar year off from football.
Yeah, by no means has it been a pretty second half, but you try to find the silver lining in everything, and assuming all goes well, Judson should be able to get their first win of the season here.
So first down and goal from the 18 as the handoff goes to, I think that's Boyd, and he falls down short. He's upset with himself because he knows that could have gone the distance.
Yeah, he had a big hole there. That probably would have ended up with six if he stayed on his feet.
And so we get a timeout from Madonna. That's their final timeout. And we'll keep it here. Judson, a productive game, a touchdown in the first three quarters. They're circling maybe having a touchdown here in the fourth quarter. But we know it's been kind of a less pretty game in the second half than it was in the first. But what did you see from the rushing game today for Judson schematically that worked so well for them?
Well, they did a really good job early in the game running the ball in the B gap, whether it be to the left side or the right side. In the second half, we've seen a lot more off-tackle runs. But in terms of Mackey, he's just been really decisive. One cut, going downhill, and does an excellent job of keeping those legs moving and getting yards after contact. Like you said today, he's been great. You got to give credit to his offensive line. They've been tremendous, especially the left side. I was very impressed all day with DeVries and Silverstrand, but 200 yards for Mackey. I'd argue about 150 of them have come after contact.
Second and goal from the 15. Two receivers high, empty set on the bottom of the formation. Now the man in motion is Siebens. The handoff goes up the middle. This one going towards the goal line, motoring there, and it is in for the score.
Wow, a heck of a run there. And that is what you love to see from an offensive line, finishing the play.
Yep, that's the dagger right there. If you were cautious before, you can very calmly say now that this game is over. Brandon Mackey, I believe, was the ball carrier there, either him or Sharon Boyd. It was Boyd for 14 yards and a touchdown.
Yeah, impressive night for Mackey, and even more impressive night for this offensive line.
Sharon Boyd, an extremely efficient runner this afternoon. 9 attempts, he's got 60 yards, and that 16-yard touchdown run was his longest of the day. Nigel Bruce also had 4 carries for 46. So essentially, Judson gets 3 50-yard rushers on the day.
Yeah, it's been an efficient day on the ground. A flag might negate this point after. Yeah, I thought it was a false start.
It was a false start actually on the kicker. If you saw Colino there, was kind of leaning a little bit early. Timing got messed up, and so they'll retry the extra point here. This time from a couple yards back.
He's got a good leg, and he's had a good day. That field goal earlier in the quarter made it a 15-point lead, and he's had a couple of nice punts too.
So Judson will pick up a conference win and their first win of the year. Next week, they travel to Olivet Nazarene, which was their homecoming matchup last year. They did lose that one handedly, but it's a brand new season. If you can transition that run game over to Olivet Nazarene. Man, they might have their hands full as the extra point is good. 31-9, under 2 minutes to go. We're in the closing moments of homecoming here at Streamwood High School, hosting Judson University this afternoon. We take a break. Back in a minute. Ensuing kickoff. Colino set to restart play. He'll kick deep to the combination of Deshaun Hayes and Jacob Ireland. Cleaning a couple things up here too, Jared, as we enter the latter stages of our broadcast. Levante Vickers with 8 catches today. His 5th was his 100th career reception as a Judson Eagle.
Yeah. Yeah, a really efficient day. We haven't seen a whole lot of the passing game, but enough to get some strong attention from the opponents. Wow.
The squib kick fielded by one of the up men. And that's number 30, Mitchell Stroll, a redshirt freshman. Takes that up to about the 36-yard line. Send the Crusaders back onto the field for one final stand. Levante Vickers finishes the day as the lead man in terms of receptions. Les Novell Chestnut gets 4 catches on this drive. Vickers with the 8 that you mentioned, Jared. Got 74 yards as the lead receiver right now. Chestnut also has 73. We'll see how this final drive shakes out for the Crusaders as DePaulis gets out of trouble, fires down the left sideline, and that's caught by Garrett inside the Judson 35.
Yeah, good job by DePaulis extending the play and finding the man on the other side of the field. I didn't even see it, but give him credit, he did.
Sitting in that soft zone under the safeties, it looked like, and was just able to find a nice little spot, settle, and set for his quarterback as now it's first down and 10 from the 35. DePaulis with 2 receivers to either side. He drops back, looks over the middle. This one's fired incomplete. The intended receiver was number 86. Alan Fordham III.
Even if you don't get points here, you just want to see a drive end with a lot of yards covered, and maybe you can take that into next week's game against Lawrence Tech. Any positive you can build off here.
You have to look at this as kind of a two-minute drill, a live two-minute drill, even if you have no chance of winning, as the pass goes to the far side, hauled in.
Yeah, really nice job there. That was in sync, too. Talk about receiver quarterback timing. That was it on the comeback route.
Brandon Brown on the tackle. Now another first down, ball placed on the 24. Wallace takes the snap, looks left, fires toward the sideline, and looks to be caught over there.
And just trying to keep everything in front of you. I think after, if they get one more first down, then you start playing a little bit tighter. But right now, you're allowing these completions.
That was Harim Carreras with the catch over on the far side. Didn't go for any yardage, I don't believe, so it'll be second down and 10, where they waved it off. Likely waved it off.
Yeah, I thought he got his feet down.
The Judson faithful still at full throat. They know they're circling in on a W. DePaulis to the left side. This one falls incomplete in the vicinity of 2 receivers. Brandon Brown was there in coverage as a safety.
Yeah, I think that's a play where you would like to see DePaulis keep and use his legs to pick up the first down.
48 seconds left in this game. It's third down and 10. Crusaders likely to stick through the air here. The only real decision they have. Again, these live reps for a team like Madonna, who's looking to get their offense right, especially with their second string QB in there. DePaul is towards the end zone. A little bit too much heat. It was Devontae Garrett as the target. Now it's fourth down. Last try for the Crusaders.
I don't know what you draw up here. I think you still just play for the first down. You don't need a touchdown. maybe. You're seeing a lot of zone, so you want to see probably routes where guys are going to come to a stop, so a hitch. Maybe a corner if you can get some leverage on the outside.
We did talk a lot today about the great defensive line for Judson as the ball goes to Chestnut. He drops it. It's incomplete. And it's a turnover on downs with 38 seconds left.
And he had him, too. Unfortunately, couldn't hang on to it. Probably would have been good enough for the first down, too.
But just a quick note on the defensive line for Judson. Three sacks today was a great showing for them, but also in the run game for Madonna, which they never really got to work on all that well. Five carries, 11 yards for Nick Allgood. Six carries, 10 yards for Arthur Brantley, who hasn't played since the first half. Spencer Rivera, four carries and 9 yards. That's it. That's all they allowed today was 30 yards on the ground.
Yeah, an impressive performance by the Judson defense. Not the second half you want to see, but hey, a win's a win.
So the offense comes back out for Judson. Take a couple knees and get out of here. Christian Miller likely to line up in the victory formation. And it is the V formation. So Judson will get out of this with their first victory of the year. They'll move to 1-2, 1-0 in conference play. Madonna falls to 0-5 on the year. 0-2 in conference play. Jared, what'd you like most from Judson today?
Defensive line, they really got after it. A great job from the get-go, forcing pressure, making the starter, Arthur Brantley, get rid of it early. This defense came to play, and that is what stood out most to me. When you have a game like this, you get multiple pass deflections behind the line of scrimmage, and then you get six sacks, you know you did your job today.
Now, if you're Herb Haygood and you're moving into week six of your season, and you've seen the performance today, what are you coaching up the most going into practice this week?
That's a good question. Probably offensively, you need to find a way to get some balance. You ran the ball at times effectively, but you also struggled to run the ball at times too. And then passing-wise, you've had a couple of big plays, but not enough to sustain consistency.
Judson cruises to a 31-9 victory on homecoming day. Christian Miller, 21-39, 199 yards and two touchdowns. Brandon Mackey leads the way and sets a program record with 194 yards on the ground, 27 attempts, and a touchdown for him as well. Sharon Boyd tacks on 60 rushing yards and a touchdown. The lead receiver in today's action, Avante Vickers, with 8 receptions for 74 yards and a touchdown. Dakari Ferguson, the biggest play of the game, 46 yards, and a TD for number one. And that will do it for us here from Millennium Stadium in Streamwood, Illinois. The Judson Eagles win 31-9. Ryan Sartori, Jared Schlensky signing off. Thanks so much for joining us this afternoon. We'll be back on the 15th of October when your Judson Eagles play the St. Francis Saints. We'll see you later.
All right, good job, guys.
Thank you.
What do you need help breaking down?
Yep.
Oh, we got it.